day, I went to drudgereport.com, and there was this image of Hillary Clinton, the glowing goddess. And I started reading news articles about it, and the more I looked at it and the more I read the transcript of what she said in her little victory speech, the more it was emblematic of how they are selling her as if she is messianic. And I noticed that CNN literally added a golden filter to her and made her shine like a god and then blurred out the background and then like Sauron in the last of the Hobbit trilogy burns with flame. It is bizarre. And it's completely and totally emblematic of how they are selling her as the savior. I remember, and we have clips of it in my film, The Obama Deception, made 8 years ago, or 7.5 years ago, they were calling him the Messiah or the Black Jesus, and that he was going to deliver everyone. All he did was, well, under his tutelage, double black unemployment the rate it had previously been. So as I've said, if that is any indication of what Hair Hillary is going to be doing to women, just get ready, because they know they've got you. They know you're drooling over it. You've been told that when she wins, you win. You don't win in your own life when you're successful. You don't win in your own life when your family's successful. You don't win in your own life when your nation's successful. You don't win in your own life when the infant mortality rate goes down. It's actually exploding. No, you win in your life when someone else that Hollywood and the spin machine has told you is a god, who is a savior. When they have great success, you supposedly live vicariously through them. And this is the very nature, historically, of cults. Thank you, Nico. I'd misplaced my paper. Newsbusters are the folks that first pointed it out. CNN depicts history-making, close quote, Hillary Clinton as a, quote, golden god. They said she looked like a golden god. And, of course, they're the ones that added the filter to it, because we went to the DNC video. I'm going to be filing a special report for the Nightly News on this tonight. Maybe we'll even do it later live on the radio/TV show here. But the real feed, that didn't happen. They just premeditated this with her in this Princess Leah goddess outfit, a.k.a. Joseph Campbell, the archetypal goddess. But that's not Princess Leah there, ladies and gentlemen. That's more like Emperor Palpatine in drag. And then she just, and then leans back, receiving it like out of some cult movie, False Doom and his mountain of power. Go forth, my children. The day of doom is at hand. Go out into the world and burn it with the great cleansing of Hillary and the great goddess. Cleanse the earth with blood. Our sacred goddess of death, Kali. I mean, this is like something out of a science fiction slash horror film where they're electing a cult demon, an antichrist, Linda Blair, complete with I can't even do it. I can try to make the most evil smile I can, and I can't catch it when she leers down and goes. We'll be back with our new Lord and Savior. Remember, we want to welcome our Lord and Savior, Barack Obama. Remember Jamie Foxx? Well, now this is even more disgusting. 10 years ago, when DrudgeReport.com started linking to Infowars.com articles with photos and videos of helicopters, Marines, Army, you name it, guarding Bilderberg Group meetings here in the U.S. and overseas, and Drudge linked to it, the, quote, mainstream media, that is the Decepticon, state-run, globalist-run media, the dinosaur media now, the on-its-last-legs media, the hanging on by its fingernails media. They came out and said Matt Drudge has gone over the edge. He's gone completely insane. He's over because he would dare link to Infowars.com and the schizophrenic beliefs of Alex Jones. The New York Times came out and said 8 years ago, at this very time of year, when Obama and Hillary were caught secretly meeting in a Bilderberg meeting where she decided to step down and quit contesting. And the New York Times, you can go read the article, said that I was having a full-on schizophrenic event, that I was mentally ill at a Marriott conference center in Chantilly, Virginia, and was imagining men in black sunglasses and suits and cars following us. We just all had it on tape, them detaining us, helicopters, checkpoints, Secret Service with submachine guns, pointing them at us as they drove by. All of it on HD video, even 8 years ago. And they said it didn't exist. Of course, now the last four or five, they've had to admit it exists but make fun of it. Now, if you read the articles, they say they control Europe. They don't want to allow the Brexit, the British exit from the Euro. They want to destroy Trump. They want a planetary regime and a global carbon tax and to censor the internet. Wow. And Drudge Report's bigger than ever, undisputed number one news aggregate site in the world with more news traffic than Facebook and the New York Times combined. And Facebook has over 2 billion users. Thousands of articles later, Drudge Report, they said, was failed and gone. And now they don't even try to deny the fact that it's dominant. And I harp on Drudge Report because it's axiomatic. It's a telltale sign, a bellwether, a gauge, emblematic. Like when you talk about a search engine, you called it Google. You still do. I'm going to Google it. Well, I'm going to drudge it. It just means your establishment talking points that up is down and down is up and black is white and mothers and fathers are bad and private property is evil. We don't follow Mark Zuckerberg, my users are dumb effers, talking points. We don't let you set the trends. Drudge doesn't even so much set the trends, but gets the global populist trend that's already out there and then adds his overall lens to it because it's what Drudge is looking at, what he's interested in, and that resonates with the general population of the world because it's synced up with them. It's a mind meld. See, that's how that works. Same thing with Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com. These are things I'm concerned with. These are things my crew is concerned with. I don't have to even tell my crew 9 times out of 10 what to go do or what to cover. They instinctively get it. They're people I hired because they were already out fighting the New World Order. They were already aware. They were already listeners. You don't have to see my worldview. It's like if you're driving along through the mountains, you know, in Switzerland in a train and look at the Matterhorn. You're all looking at the Matterhorn together. It's not like you're seeing what I told you to see. I'm saying, hey, look out this window over here. Zuckerberg wants us to look into some bag that we put over our head, and then he controls the stimulus inside the bag, literally. He wants you sitting there like a gorilla, you know, with a virtual reality hood over your head, like a Guantanamo Bay prisoner, as he walks bipedally past you in your face. And I'm like, you know what? I think I'm going to look around for myself. That's all I'm doing is, hey, look around for yourself. Hey, oh, look. Our reporters and other reporters got detained, really arrested, put in vans. Others got drug away because they dared to be in the middle of Dresden, Germany, videotaping world leaders arriving at the secret confab. But that only adds gravy to the turkey and the dressing and the potatoes and the cranberry sauce that we're exposing these people. But see, they still just don't get it. Go out and have the police arrest people, act like thugs, because nice, friendly journalists are out talking to Germans on the street and pointing out what's going on inside. Yes, toady up to the shadowy room that doesn't exist, that the establishment media told us forever didn't exist. Just like they always told us one person, one vote, and then they told us, oh, it's never been like that. Actually, the sovereign party, that's a quote from George Will decide, not you. That didn't fly, but I predicted that even though they would say he was the presumptive nominee, that as soon as he clearly clinched it, they would come back with new scandals and claim he must stand down. That's the new drumbeat last night, this morning on CNN, Fox, you name it, is that Donald Trump got even more delegates than he thought, but and he's brought in a record number of 13 million votes. We just saw the last election with how many in 2012? 10 million flat for Mitt Romney. 3 million more, record number, but none of that matters because, oh, William Kristol says at the Weekly Standard that he's going to run a third party. Even though that's failed, they cut to a Weekly Standard reporter, and he goes into a 10-minute diatribe this morning about how horrible Trump is and how he's a failure and how embarrassing he is, and then an exclusive interview that American psycho Bill Hemmer, not saying he's actually a psycho, he just looks like the actor, met with Governor Kasich. And Governor Kasich arrogantly said, I don't think I'm going to allow him to be the nominee. We're going to stand against him, as I've always said we are, because he's the head of the RNC at the convention. And then the whole show, and then the next show is all about how these Republicans, real conservatives, George W. Bush, Herbert Walker Bush, rhino, neocon, warmongering, anti-gun, knuckle-dragging tyrants, want to sit up there and say, we don't endorse him, so that's it, and we're not even going to give him the money, and we'd rather have Hillary. Because they know Donald Trump's a nationalist. And I found a video, I say found, has like 600,000 views, that we're going to post to Infowars.com the next 15, 20 minutes. I'm going to tweet it out. It's like 30 minutes long. I'm going to play the first 4 or 5 minutes at the bottom of the hour that shows Donald Trump going back 30 years, talking about nationalism, how America's getting screwed over by globalism, how these trade deals are one-sided, how he doesn't want to run for president, but that he'd like to find leadership that's willing to stand up to make this country great again. And how he's not an East Coast Republican, but a populist Republican. And I got to be honest with you, I'd read these statements in books he wrote back in the early 90s and the 2000s, but I'd never actually seen him say it. And boy, they ought to put out campaign ads with this stuff because he looks so sincere in these film clips. But we see him sincerely taking the globalist on, and that's why they're so scared of him. They're scared of him, both political machines, for a good reason, because they've hijacked this nation and the world, and he's coming along and saying, hey, you're not going to run this scam anymore. I'm coming in to try to bust this up. Now, whether he's going to be successful or not, they are in a tizzy because they have hijacked this country. They've stolen it, and they don't like anybody claiming that when a bunch of hyenas have taken down a wildebeest and up comes walking a lion, they don't know whether he wants to free the wildebeest or eat the wildebeest. All they know is he's coming in on what something they think is theirs. And if the American people don't know that the establishment is your enemy, the establishment has done everything it can to make you dependent and controlled and sold off your birthright of freedom and the industries you built, your forebears built, and tried to turn us into domesticated, drooling slobs. If you don't realize that and turn against the globalists, you're a fool. And I'm talking to new listeners. We noticed in the last week videos and articles and reports of EBT digital food stamp cards not working. And Drudge last week linked to this particularly viral video, or maybe it was Monday, of this woman just ransacking a grocery store and just freaking out and screaming because her EBT card won't work. And darn it, it's time for her to get the money. We've always talked about within a few weeks of EBT cards not working that all hell would break loose. Well, they are now reporting that all over the country, EBT cards are up to 2 weeks behind getting reloaded. And that's because, folks, we are teetering on the edge of total collapse. And when you've got 100 million people who don't work, and that's conservative, and they are entitled, and they weigh 450, 500 pounds apiece, and I'm just pointing out, can you imagine an army of 400-pound people that are so infantile when their car doesn't work, they start throwing fits like a toddler. And you know, in this case, you got black people throwing a black lady out who's going crazy. Imagine if that was white people doing it. By the way, there's plenty of videos of the Wall Martian fat white people freaking out, too. It is a time bomb. We've always talked about it. I don't know when it's going to blow, but I tell you, that fuse is getting short. So short, it's that moment where it burns down right into the bomb, and you see that red dot, and you wonder, boy, it's about to go. All right, using Drudge Report as just a example of how the true independent media is controlling the narrative 9 times out of 10 now, and how the dinosaur media has lost control with their deception. 3 days ago, Drudge began linking to Infowars.com articles every day for 3 days in a row, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, linking to Paul Joseph Watson and other articles with exclusive intel on Bilderberg. With the headlines, they're going after Trump on the agenda. They want an internet ID tax system, and they want to keep Britain from exiting the euro. We have actual sources. And then, of course, Bilderberg puts out its own press release. We grab that first, put it out, Drudge link to it. Mainstream media ignored it on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Okay, remember, Drudge top linked it. Then today, it's in the London Independent, CNBC, and a bunch of other publications. And look at the headline, World Planners Meet. Boy, you know, if top world golfers met, it'd be big news. If top Hollywood stars met, if top scientists met. But world planners meet, Brexit, migrants, Trump on menu, reporters chased away. Oh, I just looked, you just added an InfoWars link. So, because that's newsworthy. Yeah, they got detained, some got arrested. Paul Joseph Watson. So see, that's how fast Drudge moves. This is a microcosm example. So see, Drudge 10 years ago breaks the blockade. Sure, Jim Tucker, InfoWars, we were all reporting on it. Daniel Estulin, others. But breaking the blockade in the U.S. was Drudge, just showing how it's a facade. And now 10 years later, they've got to admit, okay, there's a secret government, world government meeting. Okay, yes, George Soros is involved. Yes, they want $100 trillion in global taxes every decade paid to them. And yes, they want to tax the internet and control it. And yes, they want to open the borders up. And yes, they want to kick Donald Trump out. And oh, Gawker and the White House run Media Matters, Brock, can say tinfoil hat and kook all they want. But the London Guardian, one of the most respected papers in the world, the Financial Times of London, very respected by the establishment, CNBC, the London Independent, all of them have to go, okay, world leaders are meeting in secret. And then when they go back to their parliaments and to their congresses and to their Bundestags, they get asked, what'd you do? What happened? And lawsuits start and people are removed from office. And then England goes, wait a minute. 90% of our laws are made by EU bureaucrats that are unelected. We want out. How many years did I hammer that the UK was part of Bilderberg and we'd have Lord Monckton on and we'd travel there and Lord Monckton would even travel? We made it an issue. It became the issue and we're winning. So when I get up here and brag about what InfoWars has done or what Drudge has done, it's not about us. It's about a war. And do you want to live under multinational unelected corporations that just do whatever they want and then have a bunch of weirdos in paid-off so-called media sit there in big fancy sets and laugh at you and go, build a burger? Can I get cheese and onions on that? I've probably been on radio and TV shows 200-plus times where they said, can I have a cheese on that burger? And I'm like, wow, that's really original. That is so amazing. You know, when I got arrested in Canada, and they said they were going to put me in a Toronto prison for 15 hours until the media showed up. There weren't any cheeseburgers there. I was just trying to cover Bilderberg. But the good news is all the intimidation, all the demonization hasn't worked. It's blown up in their face. The problem is, speaking of DrudgeReport.com, is that Drudge, again, is linking to Zero Hedge, great folks, and our own Michael Snyder. The problem is the mainstream media is not reporting on it yet. EBT card outage. It's been 2 weeks in some areas. It's up to 8 days in some major cities. Widespread glitches. Flashback video. Woman trashes store after food stamps refused. And you watch the chilling video that's up at drudgereport.com on the right-hand side, and you can see this woman flipping out a few days ago when her card didn't work. And this is happening all over the country. She doesn't know how to do anything. Her whole life she's been on welfare. Her whole life she sits there and watches Oprah Winfrey. Where's her free car? I love this woman. I mean, I'm sad for her. She's like a giant 450-pound toddler. She's totally deranged, and she's acting like a three-year-old. Just like Paul Watson said, social justice warriors are arrested development fools that think they're high-tech intellectuals because they watch Mr. Maddow.
I'm here to say, and this is the reason why I came to see you, Alex, is you are one of the very few who are operating under this theory to be an independent American. In a big way, if your calling is media, fine. If your calling is sports, whatever it is. But you've got to be the greatest you can be now. I don't know why they've been successful in pushing everybody into these little ghettos of these Facebooks and these tweets and these Instagrams, these Instas. This is ghetto. This is ghetto. This is corporate. They're taking your energy. They're taking your energy and you're getting nothing in return. Nothing.
They're dumbing the language down. Twitter's designed to reduce the language directly out of 1984. It's Ingsoc.
I had a Supreme Court justice tell me to my face, it's over for me. I said, Matt, it's over for you. They've got the votes now to enforce copyright law. You're out of there. They're going to make it so headlines you can't even use headlines. To have a Supreme Court justice say that to my face, that it's over. They've got the votes, which means time is limited. Time is not forever. How many more moons and sunrises will you see in your life? Rise and fall. There's not that many. It's a small amount. So for people to be saying with this attitude, oh, I'll get on with my life and my greatness sometime.
No.
No, you can't.
We're being enslaved now, and that's it. Under the TPP, they admit you can't put a headline to the New York Times. You're sending massive traffic to them. They're claiming you're taking their words. This is insane.
And you had the Justice Stephen Breyer said we need to look at a global law. Now, remember just recently
getting it lined up with it.
So they're getting ready for these decisions to come. You thought Obamacare was shocking. You thought some of these other decisions were shocking. Wait until these copyright laws work their way up and the Supreme Court decides you cannot have a website with news headlines linking across the board.
Waging war on corruption. It's Alex Jones, coming to you live from the front lines of the InfoWar.
I'm going to make more of those vignettes. Darren McBrain put that little 2.5-minute piece together when Drudge visited us last year. It's like a 45-minute long interview with just more little nuggets of what he talked about 10 months ago that now, unfortunately, all of it's coming true. And that's because Drudge obviously has a lot of high-level context, but he can also obviously see what's happening as he follows the news for 18 hours a day, as we do. And so can other people around the world. We're just pointing out common sense things here that everybody already instinctively knows, but we're letting everybody know you're not alone. MSNBC, CNN, all these channels, they're about making you think you're alone. Ha, 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 these racists don't want Obamacare. Hey, this subsection says it doubles and triples prices. Shut up, racist. Well, actually, I just want to, you know, keep my health care. Shut up. Well, it says here I'm going to lose my doctor. No, it doesn't. Yeah, read the subsection. Gruber's like, thank God they're so stupid that they never actually read the subsections. We can screw them over. They go on C-SPAN and say you're dumb. Zuckerberg says you're dumb. Well, there may be a large portion of the population that is in a coma. But just because they're going along with it doesn't mean you have a right to screw me over. In a pure democracy, 51% can vote to rob the other 49%, to enslave them, whatever. In a republic, there are basic rights that the majority cannot vote to take away the minority's freedoms. And they've got us so obsessed with what skin color we've got or where we came from being the only rights or things that are involved. As a general human species, It's in the news every day that they're building a world with robots replacing us. People say, fine, I'll just sit around all day. If it isn't a world built by humans, for humans, maintained by humans, we will be obsolete, obsolescent. Even if the social engineers, and this is profound, don't want to get rid of us, we will be like 500-pound creatures in the movie WALL-E floating on a galactic cruise ship already dehumanized. But guess what? The elite aren't going to let us just sit here and operate like jellyfish. The decision has been made to hasten our decline, to hasten our slouching into obsolescence, and to have an organized, incremental phasing out of Homo sapiens sapien. And that's what every white paper, every Wired magazine futurist report, every Ray Kurzweil Google board member statement says. In fact, there was like four articles yesterday, two or three the day before that, five or six the day before that I had in my stack, in the technology stack that I meant to get to. And I'm like, you know, I've already said this 5,000 times. Why read them saying it again exactly as I told you they would do? Because I was only quoting them previously. It's like, how, they're saying exactly what Alex said on the news today. That's because they've gone from the boardrooms and the drawing rooms when I was telling you this stuff 20 years ago off white papers and freaking out to now putting it on TV because they're getting ready to go operational. And that's what's scary. Global financial taxes, phasing out of cash. You'll still have cash, but it'll be digitally marked and track its whole history. Cash is going to be like credit cards, you know, all tracked. The police will just drive by and grab money right out of your credit card or debit card. I saw that on the drawing board years ago. It's now being done. Covered that yesterday. In fact, that's so unbelievable. Let me just I'll give you the headline. This is Oklahoma 9 TV. Oklahoma Highway Patrol uses new device to seize money used during the commission of a crime. That's the whitewash article today. The newspaper headline, will you guys give me yesterday's article, was more hardcore. It was like, in new asset forfeiture seizure, police are going to take money directly out of your debit card from a distance. You may have heard of civil asset forfeiture. That's where police can seize your property in cash without first proving you committed a crime. Oh, guilty until never proven innocent. Without a warrant and without arresting you, as long as they suspect that your property is somehow tied to a crime. That is so unconstitutional. They've had it since the 80s. It's under letter of mark. It's the really big, bad, evil thing the police are involved in. But what they do is they cut the funding to the point where the police can only operate off of asset forfeiture. They got federal laws passed where the states can't keep the money unless they go through a federal program that up to 85% goes back, hence federalizing police. That's the other big secret. Now the Oklahoma Highway Patrol has a device that also allows them to seize money in your bank account or on prepaid cards. That's right. No judge, no jury. We just are going to grab money off your debit card. It's called ERAD, or Electronic Recovery and Access Data Machine. And state police began using 16 of them last month. Here's how it works. If a trooper suspects you may have money tied to some type of crime, oh, this is the trooper. Who needs a judge? Who needs a jury? Who needs a grand jury? Who needs an indictment? Who needs a DA? Here's how it works. See how News 9 reports it like it's fun? Here's how it works. You stick your head in the guillotine, they pull the switch, and a big giant razor blade falls out and chops your heads off. It's so much fun. Oh, I'm sorry. Here's, remember ABC News last week? It's wonderful. Every child will have a microchip. You know it's coming. That's a quote. Here's how it works. If a trooper suspects you may have money tied to some type of crime, the Highway Patrol can scan any cards you have for and seize the money. You mean he just suspects or she suspects? And remember all the news reports about different areas of the country where the corrupt police pull you over and it's an old lady with $3,000 in her wallet, in her purse? And the cops just take it, and then the local judge goes, well, we tested the money, and some of the bills had cocaine on it. Well, almost all money that's been circulated has drugs on it. That's known. That's our proof. And they'll tell the old lady, you let us have the $3,000, or we're taking your Cadillac. And most of them just go, because, you know, old ladies are smart and don't keep all their money in the bank because they lived through the Great Depression. How police took 53,000 from a Christian band, an orphanage, and a church. You know, I'm not anti-police themselves individually, because I know there's a whole Soros scapegoat, the police, so they can federalize them. But this asset forfeiture seizure and the IRS grabbing money out of accounts with no due process and now saying, oh, we're not going to let you leave the country if we're investigating you. Or now you can't get on a plane if we're investigating you. Now they want that. This is so totalitarian. You know, here's my problem. I've got like 200 articles and they're all just this insane. And I've got this powerful Donald Trump video I want to play. And I've got loaded guest on. Loaded guest. You know, and I almost don't want to be presumptive about the Trump campaign. But the truth is, we're in the zeitgeist of the Trump campaign. And obviously, Trump talks about InfoWars on the campaign trail almost every day. Our fans are out there. He gets briefings with our info. Corey Lewandowski constantly tries to block it and speaks out against me and says, oh, gosh, don't go on that show. And sure, we like to get Trump on, but it's not that big a deal. Breaking big news is what's a big deal. But it is good to see, you know, you heard Roger Stone yesterday. He goes, let me just say I'm smiling with a Cheshire Cat smile right now because Trump is back on the offensive. What that means is he's back listening to Stone. And I was told last week on air, you were told, and I was told over the weekend by Larry Nichols, that he was talking to the high-level folks in the Trump campaign and that they wanted to have the info relayed over this show so it was recorded and so they could give it to Trump. And he's given me a lot of good tips over the years, but it was just like, really, Larry? Every week you're going to come on and speak directly to them, and he goes, well, they're preparing something in a week and a half, and he's going to have a big speech on it, and he talked about it, about Hillary and the latest crimes, and he's one of the top experts on that. You know, behind the Clinton Chronicles and so much more. And I knew he was telling the truth, but I was just like, okay, Larry, but we've already told everybody all this. And he says, well, that's how they want it relayed. And then sure enough, Trump comes out yesterday and goes, or 2 days ago in his victory speech, and goes, next week, probably next Monday, I'm going to have a major speech on the crimes of Hillary. And Nichols said that a week ago. So, I mean, I know Nichols is telling the truth. It's just, it's kind of unreal to be in the zeitgeist at that level. It's not like a power trip. It's actually kind of, the responsibility of it is overwhelming, is the word. I mean, I feel overwhelmed. I'm in over my head, but here's a newsflash. Anyone in the world who thinks they're not in over their head with all this wild technology and all these crazy developments and all the changes happening and all the moves towards singularity, these arrogant people that think they're in control, these big multinational corporations and things, I've met a lot of them, they really are delusional. They're specialists. A lot of them have kind of like Asperger's disorder. They're super smart in ways, but they're missing overall well-roundedness, and they just don't have enough restraint and enough understanding that no man is infallible. They have that megalomaniacal arrogance that always goes before a fall. And they make so many mistakes and screw up so much already as the power of humanity increases with our technologies and our weapons. I liken it to a chimpanzee that you've given PCP and a bottle of tequila and set it loose in a explosives factory with a flamethrower. So that's the best humanity can offer with these elites. The worst of us are running things that scampered in control and who got involved in family fortunes and you know, were good at lying and stealing and manipulating, and then they seize control of all these technologies and all these systems, and they're in control. And they're totally arrogant, off their rockers, nuts. I've been at multiple parties where I've been around some of the top tech people. And let me tell you, they are more wild-eyed and crazy than rock stars. They are on drugs. There's all sorts of designer drugs these billionaires are on. They are whacked out of their brains. They've got some kind of drug that was produced at the University of Texas and then divvied out. It's a combination of ecstasy, PCP, LSD, and peyote, and all these other designer drugs, and they're running around on this stuff. I mean, God help us. They've got drugs like Limitless that actually increase your IQ. I mean, all that stuff's real, folks, and they're on it. They don't let the general public get a hold of it, because to get the precursors that you need to make these drugs, you've got to get a lot of other controlled substances, and that's why these drugs aren't available to the public. But they got drugs that they're ready to roll out on the public that basically take your free will and people kill their own kids for. You think people do bad things for heroin and cocaine? Wait till the super drugs get rolled out. Truly designer drugs. All right, I'm going to go to break, and I'm going to come back with, just in the intro, with an extremely powerful Donald Trump piece. And then I'm going to get into all this other news, but there is just so much of it. We're going to get into more on Hillary depicts history-making, CNN depicts history-making Hillary Clinton as a, quote, glowing god. I talked about this some already, but this is just freakazoid. This just spells disaster. It spells civilization on the edge of collapse. Every time in history that we allow the elites to start acting like this, it's a manifestation and a reflection of ourselves, and it means that you can stick a fork in us. We're about to roll over dead like a big, fat, bloated, rotting whale on the shore that's got birds feeding on it and that stinks a mile away. I mean, you've got this evil crone with a big jack-o'-lantern smile, worse than any Marvel comic Joker, in a goddess outfit with a big pumpkin head that looks like a rubber mask, smiling and leaning back. I mean, if you're a radio listener, you've got to tune in next segment when I show this again. It is over the top. Briefly, I'm not going to belabor this. We've been sold out of this since December. We only had one run of it. It is 120 capsules, enough to do a six-week cleanse. That's the life cycle of most parasites. A lot of them are a week or two, but the furthest out is six weeks generally with the general parasites. I mean, not the big ones like Hillary, but the small ones that infest about 90% of the people in the world. Big Pharma doesn't want you to know about this because they'd rather you just get sick and treat it forever. But yourself, your children, you name it, it's totally safe for everybody, but still consult your physician before you walk out the door every day. But everybody needs this, and the big nutraceutical experts, the nutraceutical buffs, just all give it 5 stars. It's very, very affordable. It's available at InfoWarsLife.com. Despite the fact that it's been sold out for 6 months, we are discounting it right now, massively out of the gate. So check it out at InfoWarsLife.com today. It's normally $44.95. It's a big bottle. It's now $34.95. And the reason it's so hard to source is we all want everything in there to be California standard, which is almost impossible. There's more lead in the air or in an apple than what they allow. So lawyers get to sue everybody. That's why they passed it, was to shut down the nutraceutical business. But we just test and test and test until our products pass that. And so it's taken us 6 months to be able to get a batch that passes it because it's got so many ingredients. That's the trick. You get a few things that are totally clean. When you get like just like 30 different things in it, it's hard. You need this, and we need the funding. So detox, de-cleanse, get rid of the bad parasites, get rid of the bad harmful organisms. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com is the general umbrella site, and support the broadcast at the same time. And also get your Hillary for Prison t-shirts. You can also call toll-free 888-253-3139. Now, this is a 27-minute video. We're going to be posting it up on InfoWars.com momentarily. The title of the video is, "This video will get Donald Trump elected if it goes viral." And it is Donald Trump in the last 30 years. And we actually have a timeline we're posting in the video at InfoWars.com. And this is Donald Trump going back 30 years. Now, the name of the YouTube video is "This is Why Donald Trump Deserves to Be President." We're going to change it on InfoWars to give it more promotion. This has 600,000 views. It needs about 50 million views. And this is what he's always stood for. And I know a bunch of people that have known him for decades, they say, listen, he's anti-New World Order. He's played along with these people forever. He kept hoping the country would get turned around. He gave money to pro-America groups, anti-NAFTA GATT groups, which he did. He wrote articles for newspapers about it, and he doesn't want to be president. He doesn't want the scrutiny. He wants people to live his life and play golf. And, yeah, he likes women. Just like King David did. You know, I'm not judging him. Nobody's perfect, but his heart's right. And that's why they're so scared of him. But I'm going to air just 3 or 4 minutes of this video right now. Then we're going to come back in the next hour and show Hillary and this bizarre behavior where she's a goddess and CNN says she's a god. Are you a god? Well, no. Then die. Remember that from Ghostbusters? I mean, this is crazy. This is crazy. Hillary Clinton has got 7 million less voters than she got in 2008. Trump's got 3 million record over anybody else, 13 million. But he's the loser, Fox says, CNN says. They all agree he's a loser. Hillary's way ahead in their fake polls. They're running a jack-o'-lantern corpse against him. Let's go ahead and play this clip of the real Donald Trump.
Would you like to be the president of the United States?
I really don't believe I would, Rona, but I would like to see somebody as the president who could do the job, and there are very capable people in this country.
Why wouldn't you dedicate yourself to public service?
Because I think it's a very mean life. I would love and I would dedicate my life to this country, but I see it as being a mean life, and I also see it that somebody with strong views and somebody with the kind of views that are maybe a little bit unpopular, which may be right, but maybe unpopular, wouldn't necessarily have a chance of getting elected against somebody with no great brain but a big smile.
This sounds like political presidential talk to me, and I know people have talked to you about whether or not you want to run. Would you ever?
Probably not, but I do get tired of seeing the country ripped off.
Why would you not?
I just don't think I really have the inclination to do it. I love what I'm doing. I really like it.
Also, it doesn't pay as well.
No, it doesn't. But, you know, I just probably wouldn't do it, Oprah. I probably wouldn't, but I do get tired of seeing what's happening with this country. And if it got so bad, I would never want to rule it out totally, because I really am tired of seeing what's happening with this country, how we're really making other people live like kings, and we're not.
You've said, though, that if you did run for president, you believe you'd win.
Well, I don't know. I think I'd win. I tell you what, I wouldn't go in to lose. I've never gone in to lose in my life. And if I did decide to do it, I think I'd be inclined. I would say that I would have a hell of a chance of winning, because I think people, I don't know how your audience feels, but I think people are tired of seeing the United States ripped off. And I can't promise you everything, but I can tell you one thing. This country would make one hell of a lot of money from those people that for 25 years have taken advantage. It wouldn't be the way it's been. Believe me.
By the way, go ahead and fade this down. This is him on Larry King Live like 25 years ago. I should probably play this, and for radio listeners, mention what year it is. That's what makes it so powerful. Starts with him 30 plus years ago, right through to today. It's the same guy, folks. It's the same guy. But then he has this image as the Apprentice host. That's what folks think of him as. But the real Donald Trump is a nationalist and a patriot who played ball with all the New York liberals. All right, if you just joined us, Larry Nichols, who over a week ago said that Trump was about to be coming out against Hillary for other crimes, and he was feeding info to the Inquirer and to the Trumps, but he wanted to do it on this show so that there wasn't any actual connection between the two. And sure enough, Trump comes out 2 days ago and says, I'm about to come out with a major speech next week and go after Hillary for her other crimes. There is a 27-minute compilation that we just posted to Infowars.com, and the headline is, this video will elect Donald Trump if it goes viral. It's not even our video. I'm pushing it. Want to get it out there. But under the video, there's a timeline. This is why Donald Trump deserves to be president. Must-see compilation. 36 years ago, he talks to Rona Barrett and breaks down how we're being screwed over and he wants to stand up against the globalist. 29 years ago, he talks to Oprah Winfrey about it. He talks about it at the GOP convention 28 years ago. 1989 interview, 27 years ago. C-SPAN interview, 25 years ago. Press interview, 17 years ago, right through to a 2015 press event. Very important video. An article should be written about it, but it's up on Infowars.com. It just went up there. Hit refresh. Send the links out to everybody you know. I'm going to play a few more minutes of it right now, but there it is. This video will get Donald Trump elected if it goes viral. Now, Separately, look at DrudgeReport.com. If you're a radio listener, go there. World planners meet, Brexit, migrants, Trump on the menu. We broke that 3 days ago. Now it's mainstream news. But what did Drudge do? Drudge linked to us over the last 3 days, forcing them to then go and do their job at CNBC and the London Guardian and the Independent. And then what does Drudge link to? Top link on Drudge. Reporters chased away. Actually, some reporters were arrested. But that's Watson's tendency to not over-report. He ends up under-reporting. He's a great guy. He's probably my overall best reporter. And I don't want to say that because everybody's great in different ways. But he's the most prolific. He's the most successful. There you go. Say it that way. But Bilderberg, cops detain, harass reporters, mainstream media, nowhere to be seen. Henry Kissinger heckled as annual confab of global elite begins. And there's video of it, all the rest of it. And it's just amazing to see all of this unfolding. So the coverage is all there. Top world leaders meet. And there's the former head of the EU, Barroso. He still heads it up because they put themselves on these boards that have all the power. It's amazing. And then the police are there freaking out and acting like reporters behind government-paid-for big fences are the bad guys. But here's the good news. The elite didn't want to be recognized. They don't want it known that they're out there. It's happening. We are identifying the fact that this is going on. Let's play a few more minutes going out to break of this must-see Donald Trump video of him from the past. We're now up to like 27 years ago. Here it is.
No, it doesn't. But, you know, I just probably wouldn't do it, Oprah. I probably wouldn't, but I do get tired of seeing what's happening with this country. And if it got so bad, I would never want to rule it out totally, because I really am tired of seeing what's happening with this country, how we're really making other people live like kings, and we're not.
You've said, though, that if you did run for president, you believe you'd win.
Well, I don't know. I think I'd win. I tell you what, I wouldn't go in to lose. I've never gone into losing my life. And if I did decide to do it, I think I'd be inclined. I would say that I would have a hell of a chance of winning, because I think people, I don't know how your audience feels, but I think people are tired of seeing the United States ripped off. And I can't promise you everything, but I can tell you one thing. This country would make one hell of a lot of money from those people that for 25 years have taken advantage. It wouldn't be the way it's been. Believe me.
But you are what might be classified as an Eastern Republican. Fair?
I guess you could say that, yes.
Which means kind of a Rockefeller, Chase Manhattan Republican?
I never thought of any of those terms.
How do you define it? Are you a Bush Republican?
No, I think I'm really, the people that I do best with are the people that drive the taxis. You know, wealthy people don't like me, because I'm competing against them all the time, and they don't like me, and I like to win. The fact is, I go down the streets of New York, and the people that really like me are the taxi drivers and the workers, et cetera, et cetera. I mean, I really get
a great
response.
Why are you a Republican?
I have no idea. I mean, I am a Republican because I just believe in certain principles of the Republican Party.
You have flirted.
All right, go ahead and fade that down. We're going to come back with more of this, too. This is powerful. It's up on InfoWars.com. But that's the intel. He does what he wants. He does it his way. He doesn't cozy up to these people. He hangs out with regular folks. They hate his guts. The truth is, his dad was blue collar. We'll be back. And we are back live, ladies and gentlemen. I barely got into the seat here because I was busy like a little beaver back there working on all these breaking news stories that we're about to get to. There is a video up on InfoWars.com if you just joined us that is very, very important. I played like 6 minutes of it so far throughout the day. I'm going to be playing the rest of it here and there, spaced out. And it's Donald Trump going back 36 years ago to 1980 in a Rona Barrett interview right through to a 2015 press event. And it is Donald Trump 100% consistent on being a constitutionalist and anti-globalist and not liking to see America get screwed over. The headline is, this video will get Donald Trump elected if it goes viral. Separately, because I know a lot of stations just joined us, many stations just carry the second and third or fourth hour, headlines on DrudgeReport.com. World planners meet. What an amazing image of a world leader looking down on the earth. The British exit, migrants, Trump on the menu, reporters chased away. And why is that so important? That's CNBC, that's the London Independent, the London Guardian, all reporting and others, forced to admit the shadow world government. And that meanwhile, they still have other media outlets saying it doesn't exist. There's no shadowy group, you know, nothing's happening. But I go back to Drudge Report on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, linking to InfoWars.com, with the exact same headlines and intel that it's, they're going after Trump. They want an internet world tax. They want to open the borders up more. They want to stop Britain from leaving the euro. And now mainstream media says, according to their sources, it's the exact same agenda. When before, mainstream media wouldn't even admit it existed. The point is, InfoWars is leading the way with DrudgeReport.com and forcing the whore media, the traitor media, the Judas Iscariot, Benedict Arnold, Brian Williams, Katie Couric, discredited fraud system. The face in the crowd media is absolutely being shown for what it is. What a defeat for them to have to admit world government, to have to admit global carbon taxes. How are they going to get all this when it isn't just something that shows up on your gas bill or your phone bill or your insurance bill? There's not supposed to be a public debate about it. It's just supposed to be everything's run by these secret treaties, and that's the end of it. And we just shut up and go away and accept Obamacare. Except we're not going to just accept it. We're going to show your leaders calling us dumb idiots like Gruber did. We're going to show Zuckerberg calling us dumb effers. We're going to show how it's all a giant screw job. We're going to show the globalist plan, and we're going to derail it. This is so historic, and we're so close to beating them, ladies and gentlemen. They don't want us to be prosperous. They want us poor so that we're controllable. That's what Agenda 21 and Agenda 2030, the new second part of the Rio de Janeiro agreement is to bring in, quote, austerity, impoverishment, planned impoverishment. And once that talking point, which is their own talking point, isn't just at Davos meetings and Bilderberg meetings, but is out in the open, it's the beginning of the end for David Rockefeller and George Soros and Henry Kissinger and Hillary and all their minions and all their crones and Prince Philip and his son, Prince Charles, who are all admitted eugenicists that say get rid of 80% of the world's population, produce viruses to kill us, bring in world government while they live like kings. They have been cutting off the last 5 years the gas allotment to widows and widowers, impoverished people in England, for, I'm talking in the winter, 300, 400 pounds. That's what it cost. Maybe, you know, maybe $600, $700 is the equation. We've covered it here. So that people are freezing to death in the winter. And old people are going and getting on buses that have heating to not freeze to death at night and being kicked off, while over 100 palaces of Her Majesty are heated in a giant multi-billion-a-year pound, multi-pound, multi-billion-pound-a-year program to heat the palaces with gas. Let them eat cake. They say Marie Antoinette didn't say let them eat cake because they were starving to death. She goes, let them eat cake. But you know what? I do know Queen Elizabeth said, let them freeze their asses off. You keep my 100 palaces hotter than a firecracker. Oh, and the sick freaks. You can't have air conditioning in cars, Obama told Africans. Remember that? I quote that every day because that's the essence of these people. They teach you that you being poor is how we get ahead with all this guilt instead of creating clean, good systems. Oh, they've got their clean systems. Those are boondoggles to steal money, give it to their friends, and not allow innovation. Trump shatters Republican primary vote record. Historic 13 million blowout, 3 million more than Romney. Beat own campaign predictions, reaching 1,536 delegates. We're talking almost 300 more than they need. Latino support for Trump on rise, up to 37% from 22% in major polls. Surge of new citizens eager to vote against him hasn't materialized. Dems are down 7 million votes from 2008. Obama warned, back off Bernie. Isn't that just cute? Oh, but you watch Fox, it's, oh, Trump's doing bad. He's not trending well. The Republicans have to remove him. They're back again. William Kristol and John Kasich said so. And I watched over and over again this morning, Fox News, just monitoring them. And they were just all up there talking about how Trump can't win. And it's all a giant hoax. Trump will win unless they assassinate him or steal the election. And then everybody's asking me, how could Bernie not be winning when he got more delegates? Well, the superdelegates said no. And Hillary gets up and says, I will not be indicted. Watch, just exactly what our guest said a year ago and 11 months ago and 10 months ago and 9 months ago. And then every week since then, as the quickening accelerates, Larry Nichols, the former handler of the Clintons to a great extent when they were co-governors there, saying the whole thing is a red herring to make her the underdog. And now we've seen the bizarre footage coming up of her with them saying she is a goddess in a white outfit where they put a filter on and she glows like the sun. And they go, she is God. CNN actually goes, God, she is a god. With a giant jack-o'-lantern head smiling like the most psycho. She looks scarier than Jack Nicholson when Jack Nicholson does that scary smile. Can we pull up Jack Nicholson's scary smile and show her? It's like Jack Nicholson's head doing a demonic smile. And the screenshot we have there isn't even... Just you roll it while Larry Nichols talks. He's on the phone today. Roll just that video of her when she leans back like a god and then goes, oh, on a power trip, and then does this bizarre jack-o'-lantern crazed look. Like she's coming through a door with a battle axe. Here's Johnny. And she goes, your mother does, you know what your mother does in hell. We now take you to Arkansas, where the man is fighting cancer. We appreciate how much he's gone through to be able to even be with us. And that's Larry Nichols. Larry, I got to hand it to you. You said, hey, I'm talking to the Trump people. We don't want to have her. You know, they've called me. They don't have a, you know, it was your idea to not actually meet with them. They make a big deal out of it. I think you should just go meet with them, though. I know you're battling cancer. And you just said, hey, I'll just do it over your show. And he's going to be giving a speech soon about all this. And he said, yes, next week he's doing the speech. So just that's just interesting. Give us the scoop on that and then tell us the intel that you're relaying to the dossier that they've got lawyers researching and vetting to go after Hillary next week and this big speech that Trump announced.
Well, by the way, hello, Alex. Thanks for having me.
You bet, Larry.
Let me come on because the whole process that I want to achieve. Now, remember, Alex and audience, I want nothing official with my relationship with the Trump people, if there is such a thing, relationship. What I want is a candidate that I know when we bring an issue out, like on your program, when we bring an issue out, then we need a candidate running against Hillary that will take that and help spread it around. Not hard. Simple. That's all we got to do. Short of having somebody like Trump run, we're screwed because what's always happened when other people are in the race and the Trump is not, they're so connected and need everybody else's money so bad that they become pliable.
That's right. That's right. Trump will bully pulpit the anti-New World Order message and make America great again. That's why they're crapping their pants.
You bet. And so anyway, my strategy will be I'm going to serve up, with your permission, on your program every week, basically like we did when Bill Clinton was in office, scandal a week. We're going to try to start off a little better than that, but for continuity's sake, we'll try to stay at a new major scandal every week.
Okay, now a lot of the stuff you talked about 3 weeks ago did come out in the Inquirer, and you're one of their sources, and Trump is obviously, you know, the folks are tuned in, vetting your claims here. I know your claims to be accurate, and we've been talking for 20 years on air, Larry. So let's start getting into it right now. This is so important. I'm skipping this one break today. Let's get into what are we serving up this week? I mean, what's coming next? What's going to be in that speech next week to Trump?
Well, to that end, I can't say because I don't know. I know what's going to be served up is Vince Foster. I know, Alex, and you do as well. We've been told by the media that's old news. It's done been sealed up. It's all over. Well, let's just do this. Remember when Trump had to deal with it last week? It was everywhere. The media went nuts. They were all over it, right? Imagine this week, which will be next week, actually, in his speech. Just imagine, I'm not saying he'll do it, it's up to him. But imagine him saying in his speech, folks, they say that the investigation of Vince Foster is over, that there's nothing to it. The man committed suicide. And then he ought to pick up that Secret Service memo that you have, Alex, and hold it up for the world to see and say, does this look like it's over? Does this look like, you know, the case has been solved, it was truly a suicide?
And then he could also have that Secret Service agent that just went public up there on stage with him, talking about all the horrible things Hillary did and saying, is this over? Because she's about to be your president.
Right. So that's the plan. That's what's got to happen. And then, you know, remember, Alex, you and I talked about the Secret Service memo, what, a month ago, a month and a half ago? We talked about it. Did a great job. You putting it out. People picked up on it and heard it. But guess what? It just wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. So as my training goes, Alex, you know, as a Green Beret, you become a force multiplier. That's what you have to rely on, your ability to create a bigger force. Well, think about it, Alex. If Trump were to come out and say, they're saying this case is solved and it's over. Here's the Secret Service memo. Do you really believe it's solved? Is it over? The media will immediately discredit Trump and that report, right? And when they're trying to discredit it, you know what they're doing?
Spreading it.
Spreading it. There you go.
And that's the plan.
That's what we've got to do. That's the plan.
I'm advising him the famous C-SPAN footage that I haven't even found on YouTube, but I know we've got it on VHS tapes. And they could find it because it was released via subpoenas. You remember all that. You were involved in it.
Yes,
with all the communist generals in the White House meeting and then giving Clinton money, and then the Laura Allen Hughes and the missile secrets. I would go directly to China threatening to attack us today in the South China Sea and point out that Hillary presided over giving them the delivery and reentry systems. That's high treason. Now, that's what I'm telling him. And Stone says, don't worry, that's going to be coming down the road. He says, hey, we got to dole this out. I don't know if I agree with Stone. I mean, I think he just needs to start hammering her with everything he's got.
Well, exactly. And remember, this is the first couple of days that we can do it. We had to hold back our fire until he made it through the primary. Or she made it through the primary. She's through the primary now. Now we're in the feature match. The feature match is on, folks. And we're going to beat her at every turn. We're going to beat hard. You know, Alex, sometimes, just like me with my sickness, you just want to go and go, you know, just cut off the suffering. Some things are too important. You have to take your time. You have to let it build. You have to let it develop. And that's where we're at.
Okay, so Stone's right then to dole this out. How long do we dole this out then? Because I'm afraid they'll kill him before then.
Nothing I can say about that. We do it this way until we...
Sure, sure. Well, then how long would you dole it out? Up until, say, the convention?
Well, no, I would go... This is stuff that I'll be doing every damn week from now until Election Day in November.
Sure, I know, but listen, you accurately said there'll be no indictment. It's going to look like it. It's not going to happen. And now she basically quotes you saying it's not going to happen.
That's right. And you know why she said that? She said that because you know why she was able to say that. She's got the raw FBI data files. And the bad news for Hillary is, so do I. And you know, Alex, you know I got them. Now, what does that mean, folks? You see, you think, you got to not think single-dimensional. By going after the Clintons, I'm not just going after her. I'm going after every one of them. Every one of them in Washington. And the truth that she is using to blackmail and extort all these people in Washington with, we've got it. And I guarantee you there will be no quarter offered. They're not going to give me any. And I'm just going to return the favor, none for them. But the key to the Secret Service memo is to get it to where it's got legs. Then that Secret Service memo becomes significant another way because it, as you know, had any legitimate investigative body, like the FBI or whatever, had they have investigated its primary lead on it, they would have wanted to know the mitigating circumstances of why would Foster kill himself? But you see, there's no suicide note until 6, 7, 8 days later, when they literally, the pressure was on them that there was no suicide note. And all of a sudden, they go up to his office, find that magic briefcase that originally was in his car. We had that from Linda Tripp. His briefcase is in his car, and there was blood all over it. They moved that body. And, you know, we've talked about it before, Alex, the media. If they're not going to indict Hillary on that Benghazi stuff, if they're not going to indict her over that, they're not going to indict her. But we can knock the hell out of her budget. Her budget calls for, Alex, she'll spend 60 to 70% of the money she raises to destroy Trump. That's what they're going to do with it. They're going to destroy Trump.
And they're going to do it by saying he hates women and he hates Hispanics.
Yep.
And it turns out this judge is a high-level Mexican supremacist, in my view, a member of La Raza. And that's all seen as kosher by the media. But his law firm has been putting money up to boycott Trump. They have been after Trump. He should recuse himself. So what Trump said about him is true. He said, I have nothing against him, the fact that he's Mexican, but he's a Mexican who's loyal to Mexico. I don't know why you'd want to be loyal to a failed state, but it's just crazy. And that's who Obama's been putting in charge. It's just a bunch of people that won't get along with each other, a bunch of balkanized, divided and conquered folks. But that issue's moved on. I see the hoax being pushed that he's way behind her in the polls and that he's in trouble, despite the numbers and many other polls showing the opposite. What does your gut tell you the real numbers are?
My gut is accurate. Right now, it's 40-40-20. That's exactly where it is right now, 40-40-20. 40% for Trump, 40% for Hillary, and 20% in the middle and don't care. That's where it's at right now. You can run 10 million polls, and I assure you, if they show the real results of the polls, and if the questions are the ones that they normally ask, that figure of 40-40-20 will hold. And it's held up through the test of time for our founding fathers. I mean, if it was good enough for them, it's good enough for us. We just can't. We can't let them win.
Well, we're almost out of time. Specifically, give us a preview, because I want to start this, you know, as soon as we start going here. The info that you've been imparting to the Trump people are what to look at next. You just mentioned some more of the Vince Foster. You mentioned some more of the, I mentioned the Chinese generals, the missile secrets. What else should Trump get into in this speech coming up?
Well, the one thing that he must bring up in this speech is how did North Korea get their nuclear weapons.
Exactly. The Clintons pulled that out and allowed them to get reactors that could enrich uranium. That's another great point. There you go.
Yeah. And, you know, and the reason that will have appeal to the broad audience, if we can get them to pay attention long enough to hear it, that's a game changer. That's a lose-lose for America. We not only give North Korea, see, there are two technologies that could have been given to North Korea. One was that if the one system provides the power they need, et cetera, which is one thing. It does not create any byproduct or waste products that can be used to make a nuclear bomb.
That's right. They gave them a system that allows them to make atomic and hydrogen weapons. I remember the whole thing. That was like ABB, wasn't it? I mean, it's just...
Yep.
And of course...
Well, and the other thing that Trump's got to point out is that they haven't changed their stripes at all. What is the system that we've been working with in this?
The broken coalition strategy, how she's the divider. All right, Larry, we'll talk to you again.
They've made in Iran.
Okay. Oh, Iran's good, too. All right, we'll talk to you again soon, my friend. Be safe.
Well, I just hate what's happened to this country. We've gone to a country that's no longer respected. We're in a war that we should have never... And by the way, I'm worse than any hawk there is in terms of military and in terms of defending ourselves.
But Saddam Hussein didn't knock down the World Trade Center. He had nothing to do with it. And there were no weapons of mass destruction.
The other day, the head of 3M said that President Obama is anti-business. Do you get the same feeling that he does?
Well, I don't know that it's anti-business or he just really doesn't know exactly what to do. And I'm afraid it probably is the second thing. I don't see him necessarily as anti-business. I think that he is not sophisticated in the ways of business. He hasn't dealt with the people that you've dealt with and that I've dealt with. I deal with China as an example a lot. It is never easy. And I've made some very big deals with the Chinese. I've come out on top. I've come out in great shape. I sell apartments to Chinese people. I get along great with them. It's not like, you know, anti-China. I just think it's ridiculous that we allow them to do what they're doing to this country with the manipulation of the currency that you write about and understand and all of the other things that they do. And frankly, if I were them and if I could get away with it, I'd take my hat off to them, frankly. They do get away with it. And I hire companies all the time, and it's so hard for our companies to compete against Chinese companies. I mean, these companies have such an advantage, whether it's glass for a curtain wall or whether it's, and you use the term because you know what's happened, sheetrock. I mean, they used to give us sheetrock, just give it. And everybody that was unfortunate enough to use Chinese sheetrock had problems. I mean, problems like no, where people were dying from it. The good news, Steve, our product is much better, but with the manipulation of their currency, it's very, very, very hard for our companies to compete. But I'll certainly do whatever is necessary and however I can help, whether they want me to make speeches, whether they want me to contribute, raise money, I'll do whatever I have to do. We need somebody great as a president.
I know that you were mentioning that Aaron and I did a kind of an interesting video not that long ago in August about how things have fallen apart. But at that point, the only people who were saying it were us and you.
I was saying it. I was saying it a long time ago. And frankly, they're talking about 50 basis points. I think you should drop it a point, a full solid 100 basis points, and just sit back and see. And I was actually looking at somebody, a gentleman from Goldman Sachs, was saying 175. So that's going to be interesting. But I think that's ultimately going to be happy. And it would be nice if Ben could get now ahead of the curve instead of always being behind the curve. Behind the curve. Say what you want.
That is a compilation, and this is getting into more modern times, but it's really powerful the first 10 minutes or so. It's up on Infowars.com. This is why Donald Trump deserves to be president. It's the name of the video. We've put it up there on Infowars.com with the headline that this video will make Donald Trump president if it goes viral. This video will get Donald Trump elected if it goes viral. This is why Donald Trump should be president. And it's really the first 10 minutes that's the most powerful. Him back in 1980, 87, 88, you name it, talking about globalism and how it's screwing over our economy and how it's one-sided deals by the political class working with the elites. Now, shifting gears out of that, we're about to go to Dresden, Germany, the site of Bilderberg 2016. And Charlie Skelton will pop in briefly during the next hour. I'm going to cover other news, though, most of the time. He's a London Guardian reporter to give us his view on Bilderberg this year. And Anthony Gucciardi will be hosting the fourth hour with all the latest news and special reports and more. Now, there's a lot I want to get to today. So I'm just going to spend about 10 minutes with Paul Watson and Rob Dew about some of the big developments at Bilderberg this year. And then I'm going to get into the economy, the EBT card suddenly not working in different areas around the country, causing civil unrest in some areas already. We're going to get into the bizarre media, billing Hillary as a god, a goddess, a savior. But also, you know, you see these Daily Show compilations where the reporters all have the same talking point about the Easter Bunny or about Christmas or whatever. This is the same talking point about Hillary. And again, this stuff comes out of the White House. People say, why do you care about Media Matters? The website gets almost no traffic. But it's run by the White House and the Clintons, they admit. So when they put it out, that's when I get attacked at 1,000 publications. Which, by the way, I love. Keep it up, please. I mean, it's like being attacked by Hitler or being attacked by a child molester. You just still don't get. You got a 6% trust rate with the American people. Please, George Soros, Nazi collaborator-run media, White House-run media, please keep saying I'm horrible. How How's it going for you saying Bilderberg didn't exist? Now it's all admitted. World government out in the open. How's it going for you? You've discredited yourselves, but you're too narcissistic and too evil to admit it's happened. We're going to Paul Watson, because instead of just being there at the Bilderberg Hotel with their meeting, where reporters have been arrested, our reporters have been detained, harassed, you name it. That's top story on Drudge, by the way. We can put that up for a moment. Despite that, it is down the street at the train stations where the drug dealing and the raping and all the rest of it is going on, with all of the wondrous little migrants that have taken over. But before we go to Paul Watson there in Dresden, we have a new edition of the Hillary for Prison shirt, and it looks like a classic campaign shirt, but it says Hillary for Prison 2016. It's the second variant. We are not going to produce more of this best-selling shirt. We're going to keep it pretty much the same, but add Infowars.com in red to the right shoulder and leave Infowars.com Legalized Freedom on the back. But if you want to get the last variant that says Hillary for Prison Until the End of Time, it's got 4.9 stars out of 5, and you want to support the broadcast, get that limited edition now, because the new ones come in a week, and these will be sold out. We have them in all sizes still, but take advantage. We have another limited edition that shows her as the leering joker on the front. And more than just fighting the info war and spreading the word about Hillary for prison, this is about exercising the First Amendment she's been trying to attack, telling comedians, you know, they'll be audited if they talk bad about her and stuff. And it's about meeting like-minded people and showing solidarity at different political rallies. Trump, almost every day now, says, oh, look, Hillary for prison. I love InfoWars. This is it's all over news feeds. It's all over mainstream TV. Hillary for prison is being picked up. Other people are selling the shirts. I don't care. Knock yourselves out. This is about an information war. But if you want the originals from the folks that first designed it and came out with it, InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com for the nutraceuticals. So speaking of InfoWarsLife.com, we only put this out one time. It sold out in 2 days. We've had a bigger run of it made this time. It's Living Defense. It's got close to 30 ingredients in it that are all organic, all super clean. That's why we have to wait so long, because it's taken us 6 months to be able to have all these ingredients together that pass California standards. And it's everything from wildcrafted black walnut, green whole, organic. It just goes on and on. Wildcrafted Usisa bark. It's got everything in it known to detoxify: organic wormwood, organic clove bud. It goes on and on and on. Read the ingredients that detox and knock out the parasites. And the cycle of most parasites is less than 6 weeks. So one bottle for a person does 6 weeks easy a couple tablets a day. It's in powder form. They're big horse pills. And it's just so healthy overall what these herbs do. And folks taking it, it has changed their lives. Read the reviews at InfoWarsLife.com from Power Reviews. This is Willie Leek. And he says, Dr. Group products are the only supplements I recommend. All Dr. Group supplements are the only supplements I recommend to my friends and family. This was developed by Dr. Group for InfoWarsLife.com exclusively. Works great, no side effects, says Shovey from Corvallis, Oregon. I am super happy with Living Defense. My gut emptied out a few days after I started taking it. I followed the directions of the label. No discomfort. I need less sleep, and I wake up feeling better than before. Supermel Vitality is also back in stock at InfoWarsLife.com. You're crazy if you don't try it. It's our most popular product. Brain Force is an amazing nootropic. Makes me a little aggressive when I take it, but it certainly works, and it's very healthy and has amazing reviews. And your purchases make everything we do here possible. InfoWarsLife.com, or simply call toll-free 888-253-3139. There's a lot of other products, obviously, water filtration systems, promo code water to get 10% off, the amazing Alexa Pure Breeze, groundbreaking air purifying system. Just check it out for yourself and know the purchases you make finance this operation, taking the globalist on toe-to-toe, putting reporters in Germany, reporters in California, reporters all over the world simultaneously, writers, researchers, camera people, editors, anchors, customer service, legal, HR, all of it to build a real media organization. It's hard to do. Licensing, the computers, the bandwidth, it's all very expensive, even though we're in Texas. That's why we're here, because it's a lot less expensive. If I was in New York, I'd have 10 crew members, not 50. So 888-253-3139. I want to thank you all for your support, because you are the InfoWar. And you can see your support paying off big time in the fight for liberty. This is a war bond operation, a free will operation. It's basically a donation when you buy the products, but we make them the very best that we can bring you, whether it's Anthroplex or Lung Cleanse or Survival Shield Nascent Iodine X2. Okay, let's go now to Dresden, Germany. We're not at the Bilderberg hotel meeting. Now we're down the road seeing the results of globalism, the results of the EU project to implode borders. Paul Joseph Watson reporting from Germany. Paul, a lot has happened since we talked to you 24 hours a day, 24 hours ago. You're on the air. You've got a drunk there with you. Go ahead.
Yeah, this is fun. Yeah, today we've been at Bilderberg. Obviously, we had the big story last night. Do you want to be on the air? Want to be on TV?
Yes, yes. I want
This is we're at the train station here in Dresden, and this is what's taking place all around us.
Everybody with me here. What do you want to say? What's the Zaham?
You're on TV.
Yes, yes.
What do you want to say?
There you have it.
Now, is that guy from Eastern Europe a gypsy, or is he Muslim? Ask him where he's from.
I don't know. He's gone now. I'll ask him if he comes back.
We'll talk to him. He's coming back. Come on, Paul. Call him over.
Where are you from? Where are you from?
I come from Algeria.
Algeria?
Algeria.
That's North Africa.
Algeria, Afghanistan. Well, they seem to be able to speak English, the kids.
Good God. Ask this guy where he comes from.
Where are you from? Algeria. It's from Algeria.
Let's go in the train station, Paul. I know folks get attacked when they do, but what have you been witnessing? Let's...
Well...
Watch yourselves. Be careful.
There's a lot of crazy people around here, as you can see.
Yeah, that's... Watch out. Now, keep going. Just...
Bilderberg itself, we've got George Soros betting on a massive economic collapse, as he talked about earlier with the Wall Street Journal, which is interesting because we've got new intel, which is in the video, the interview with Tony Gosling, which Rob did, which is on the Alex Jones channel, which I'm going to write an article about. He's predicting that they're talking about preparing for a huge financial collapse. Now, you remember when you went to Canada in 2006, you got the intel that an American delegate said the same thing 2 years before the housing bubble popped and 2 years before the 2008 economic collapse. So it happened then. We got the intel out before, and it's happening again.
And that was directly
now.
From a Bilderberg Group member from the U.S. to Daniel Istalon. Yeah. I later learned the name of the person has also owned a large Hollywood production company, still does. We'll stop there. But when we have our sources, we're just letting folks know. And so you're saying we're getting other good intel that they're preparing for another collapse right now.
Yeah, and that comes from somebody who's got good sources. In fact, he was able to predict that Henry Kissinger would arrive at 3:25 p.m. today because some intel has been leaking. At exactly 3:25, Henry Kissinger arrived. We were able to get photographs of him. He was lectured, but he was heckled by the crowd. So,
by the way, that's
that
the top
intel.
Story on DrudgeReport.com. Some reporters were it's arrested when they put you in a van and handcuffs. But, you know, what happened to you guys on that front? Then we'll go back to the economic collapse.
Well, last night we were walking back from the restaurant back to the hotel. We walked past the other journalists that were in the report there, and almost immediately within a few footsteps, we were accosted by several police officers. We were just walking back to the hotel. We weren't even filming at that point. And so then more police officers arrived, more vans arrived. They kind of kettled us in, surrounded us, and they started obviously trying to intimidate us. This is what they do every single year at Bilderberg. They try to intimidate the press. So they basically said we were being stopped for causing a distraction. They demanded our passports. We gave them our passports. And then they demanded to bag searches. And I mean, I didn't even have a bag, so I literally had to empty out my pockets to show them what was in my pockets. They took each of us individually behind the van to search us all individually. And they were thorough. They were looking for anything that they could get us on. And then we were cordoned off to a different area. Everyone was individually searched. And we were finally given back our passports and told by the police, if you cause another distraction, you will be arrested. So we said, what is a distraction? And what constitutes a distraction? They said, causing trouble. So it's all completely vague to give the pretext the pretense to arrest us for basically nothing. And it was pretty intense. It went on for about 45 minutes.
We're showing footage for TV viewers. Radio listeners can go to Infowars.com/show to see the live feed or see all the videos posted there. Go to DrudgeReport.com. It's the top story there, along with them announcing world government internet taxes, going after Donald Trump. And it's great to see the fact that you got their agenda 3 days ago. Drudge reported on it. And now mainstream media is echoing exactly what we broke 3 days later. Boy, I mean, who are the conspiracy theorists now, Paul?
Well, I mean, Merkel herself, she came to Bilderberg 5 months before she became chancellor. You know, we got them picking Tony Blair, Bill Clinton. We got them picking NATO secretary generals. They come here, they're groomed, they're elected, they're picked, they're chosen. So it's happened time and time again. We've been proven right. You were proven right in 2006. And that's what we're hearing again now in 2016, that they're planning to pop this bubble. Obviously, there's huge problems in China with the stock market there. The luxury property market around Europe is now starting to crumble. So all the signs are coming in. And that's the intel that we've got, that they're preparing to profit from an economic collapse.
That's right. That's why Soros, who's been out of the markets and out of real estate, that they announced today, is now entering in big time. The Grim Reaper is coming in to enjoy his work.
Exactly. So we've got the video interview up on that. Again, as I said, Gosling always gets some good information because he's been tracking this for 20 years plus. So he got the information. He got the times that all the people were arriving. We use that to our benefit. And he got this information as well. So, again, there's going to be another huge article about that on Infowars.com.
I love how the cops are bugging their eyes out like you guys have done something. You're just reporters. Everybody knows who you are. And Paul, be safe out there because, you know, that's a tactic sometimes with the kids and stuff as a distraction. But I want to go inside this train station if we can in a moment and see what happens. This is where you drove by the other day and saw a bunch of the invaders dealing drugs and being arrested. We'll be right back. Coming up, I got a compilation again we're going to play next hour showing Hillary with the media just saying the exact same talking points, that she's the presumptive nominee, she's the goddess, she's invincible. Oh, this is such a moment in history. A criminal with a big giant Joker face is our Lord and Savior. That's all coming up. I'm going to have these guys ride shotgun with us a little bit in the next hour to talk about all this. Briefly, I'll tell you about an amazing sponsor we've had for a long time, but they only advertise when they have a special running. That's solutionsfromscience.com. Solutions from Science was created to help you and your family prepare for hard times. Solutionsfromscience.com, you will find a wide variety of preparedness products that were created to help keep you safe when disaster strikes. I like to have solar panels, just period, because they're good to have. From solar power generators to survival gear and fertilizers, they're all available right now through the Solutions from Science website. And Solutions from Science recently bought a surplus of solar power generators and are offering a discount to listeners who visit their website. Visit solutionsfromscience.com or call toll-free 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Really an amazing company, solutionsfromscience.com. And I'm only plugging this right now before I go back to Paul Watson because I was about to do it for myself, but there's no glass of water, so I'll get one of those during the break. I've been taking my living defense. I've been taking it for 6 weeks now that it's back in stock at InfowarsLife.com. Okay, going back to Paul Joseph Watson. Paul, you're in Dresden and folks just tuned in. All I basically see is, quote, migrants walking around. They're from North Africa. They're from the Middle East. I see a little girl there with her face covered up with the hijab. Tell us what you're witnessing, and are you going to go inside the train station?
Well, yeah, we can do. It's very different to downtown Dresden where the hotel is and where Bilderberg is staying. There's a lot of migrants around here because there's a camp nearby, which we've been told about. So we're going to visit that at some point. So, yeah, when I came in, it was pretty bad. But, yeah, it's a little sketchy. I mean, it's not awful. But, yeah, there are a lot of migrants here because they brought in 5,000 into a city that's, you know, about 500,000 people. And they're going to bring more in. Another interesting thing out of Bilderberg, though, was that we spoke to a guy who said that he'd spoken to the guy who owns the pizzeria behind the Bilderberg Hotel, which is almost, you know, directly connects to it. He was told by the police that they would have to have access to his pizzeria at all times. They could go in and out, and that it was, yeah, they would have the keys. They would own the keys to this guy's house for the period while Bilderberg is here. So we're going to go and speak to him to get his side of the story if he speaks English. And then he also said that They were bringing in special furniture into the Bilderberg Hotel days before the Bilderberg members arrived. Now, you saw from Rob's video that it wasn't a very plush hotel, not very well decorated for a five-star hotel. They were bringing in furniture that was covered, high-end luxury furniture specifically for the Bilderberg members days before they arrived. So again, that's another tidbit. And again, you know, a wink and a nod to their elitism that even a five-star hotel is not good enough for them. They have to bring in their own stuff.
Well, it's also fitting, like World War II, that they're kind of in a bunker now, not as nice a hotel, not surrounded with hundreds of acres, not as highly protected, because their whole project, the Euro, is in trouble. And I love how media is now admitting Bilderberg exists, but just says it's a secret talking group, but it's protected by governments when they're the ones that admit they created the European Union project.
Yeah, and that's what they're talking about again, the Euro crisis. Another interesting thing is one of the top German ministers came out today and said that Germany needs to accept this mass Muslim migration. They need to accept interbreeding, which is interesting because it goes back to what Gregor Gysi said, where he said it's fortunate that only the Nazis didn't have children. Remember that quote. And of course,
sure, you know, and if people want to marry somebody, that's fine. But the government says you will have sex and have kids with somebody else that isn't your country because it's bad you're white. It's bad you're German. And this is coming out of these. You guys have interviews with Germans going, good, we want to get rid of Germans. Yay, we. I mean, they're just cult members. Back in 70 seconds with Paul Joseph Watson from Dresden, Deutschland. I'm Alex Jones from Austin, Texas. We're now into the third hour. Final segment with Paul Watson. I want to let him get back to all the important work he's doing, but we're going to be shifting gears and getting Rob Dew's take on this as well. We've got three of our reporters there. All I can say is incredible job, crew. They are forcing the mainstream media to report on what's happening. Secret global government meetings, amazing. Paul, you're there at the train station. We saw a bunch of police raids, and we've seen women in hijabs walking around and kids running around appearing to be on something. I'm not sure, with another man that was drunk talking on camera saying they were from North Africa and Afghanistan. Other points, and then I'd like to, you know, basically get a ground tour for TV viewers, and I'll narrate for radio listeners.
Yeah, one other point is that there were two arrests today. There were two protesters who just turned up, calmly sat down outside the barricades. They weren't screaming, they weren't shouting, they weren't saying anything. They were holding two cardboard signs which said something like, why the secrecy, we want transparency, something like that. Completely non-offensive, there were no cuss words in the signs. After about 30 minutes, the police came up to them, and eventually it was three rows thick of police, obviously to keep us dangerous reporters away from them. They had a long conversation about how there was no free speech in Germany while Bilderberg is in the town of Dresden. And they were forced to put the signs away, and that's where it stopped in that moment. But a few hours later, the police came back and arrested them for possessing a tent. They had this little green tent. I don't know what they were doing with it, but these people who were British, they were quite polite people. They were just having a conversation with the police. But no free speech in Germany while Bilderberg is in town. And it's ironic because they were accosted by the police. And literally about 5 minutes later, Vernon Jordan arrived. I think that's his name. And he's a civil rights activist. So you've got a top civil rights activist heading into Bilderberg while within 5 minutes, people are being harassed simply for holding protest signs outside of Bilderberg and having their free speech crushed. So I thought that was kind of ironic.
Well, I mean, look, I don't say this to be sensational. In fact, I'm almost ashamed that I'm not more upset. Germany has fallen to tyranny. Germany is like Nazi Germany again, but it's leftist control. They're arresting people for rallying. They're telling people, shut up. It's horrible that Germany has police that have turned into anti-free speech thugs and who follow illegal orders. This is despicable.
Well, it's not just Germany. We saw it last year in Austria. I mean, we got pretty much the same treatment there. They kind of relented in the last couple of days.
These people when they say, we're going to arrest you if you keep covering this, I'd say Nuremberg Code. Nuremberg. I'd say Nuremberg. Remember, don't just follow orders. I would declare Nuremberg Code. That'll be in the paper and might actually wake Germans up. Like, yeah, Nuremberg Code.
We've heard reports that some of them are threatening physical violence against other reporters who are here. I don't know whether that's true. It might not be.
Oh, but those are some of the claims going around. Absolutely. Look, here's the thing. They're nice until you don't follow their orders, and they follow orders, and that's what allowed Hitler to do what he did. Be your own people. Don't be robots.
No, exactly. And I mean, in saying that, there's a lot of political activism around this city. I mean, just driving here to the
train Germans
station.
On average that are awake are great people. It's their police that have the problem.
Yeah, a lot of people seem to be informed. Some don't. I mean, a lot of the tourists that come here didn't know what was going on. But we spoke to one guy from Nepal who was an immigrant, a student immigrant to Germany. He's been here for 4 years, speaks perfect English. He was unhappy about how the media was portraying Pegida as racist. He's a Trump supporter. He's against this migrant invasion. And he's a hardworking immigrant who's learned the language, integrated. He's a big fan of us. And, you know, he sees it exactly the same way. So that was a real narrative buster. And again, that was another good interview that's up on the Alex Jones channel.
Paul Joseph Watson, amazing job. Keep dominating. Keep exposing the globalists. This is superhero-level events we're seeing with the InfoWars team linked up with DrudgeReport.com right now. The top story is Drudge dare report on a global government secret meeting and reporters being harassed and arrested. My gosh. It's like when he reported on them not having votes in Colorado. How dare him say that the election was suspended? How dare you care? How dare I care? They want to play God. They want to stay hidden in the shadows as their world government project is constructed. But they shouldn't be too proud of this technological terror. Because humanity, rising and being aware of it, will end it. We have the ultimate veto power. Now, Rob Dew's going to report with us a few minutes, then I'm going to get into all these Democrat websites and the New York Daily News and others going, but Bernie Sanders had more delegates than Hillary Clinton, just got the superdelegates who are party officials, and they're ignoring the fact that Bernie really won all these states and should be the leader. Well, and then they have all these weird socialist women going, does it matter? It's part of our socialist plan. She's a woman, so it's okay. It's like, it's okay. Ted Cruz is a real conservative, so he's allowed to get all the votes in states and suspend the voting. Or you have the voting, and then they just take the delegates. So this is a big deal. And then them saying she's a goddess on CNN and blurring everything and she shines like Jesus in his ascension or something. And they say, look at the God. So that's all going on. But right now, let's go back to Dresden at the train station to see the results of the country flooded with the illegals there. And then give us a tour. I'll narrate for radio listeners, Rob, dude.
Yeah, well, Alex, right now, the guy that was jumping around earlier, he seems to have pissed off another person who's over here. The fight might ensue in 1 second.
Well, let's go over there.
All right.
There's a drunk guy hopping around. He said he was from Afghanistan or
exactly.
Folks from Algeria.
Now, Alex, I ran around and shot a bunch of B-roll before we went on live. And just walking around here, I saw the cops questioning several groups of immigrants, just asking for their papers and whatnot. When we walked up, there was a guy showing them their ID and, and then going through the train station. One guy couldn't get on the train because he didn't have a ticket, but he was trying to get on the train. The guy said no, so he's sitting there talking to his friends. And, right now it doesn't seem like it's super busy, but it seems to be, packed with guys just hanging out, loafing around, as you would say. And, it's interesting. I talked to a family, a couple. I put the interview up on Infowars.com. She was German, he was Jewish, and they seem kind of fine with the migrants coming in. They think everybody seems to think there's this endless pool of money to pay for benefits and housing and food.
Even though most of these radical Muslims being brought in on record want to kill every Jew they can get their hands on.
That's true. And we kind of got into that at the end. And I said something in the terms of, maybe Germany has Holocaust. They feel bad for the Holocaust, so they're letting these people in to make up for it. And he didn't want to get into that, and that kind of pissed him off. And then
it's globalism. It's a project to end Europe. It's a project to create total division. They're bringing in people that just sit around on a bunch of bums and, adopt every form of crime you can imagine, because under Islam, it's okay to commit crimes right. Against non-Muslims.
Exactly. And, another interesting thing that happened today, people were coming up to us, wanted to know what was going on. All the tourists were, the tours were going through, and they would stop. They would hear us speaking English. What's going on? What's going on? So then I just started videotaping these people and saying, well, I'm going to have to videotape you if I'm going to tell you what this is. You're going to get educated. And so we just, you know, I started telling them about the Bilderberg group because there wasn't much going on for a few hours. We're sitting there waiting. I guess the highlight was two highlights were Vernon Jordan and Henry Kissinger. I have yet to see Lindsey Graham show up.
Well, let me ask you this question.
Yeah.
They just started arriving, you know, today, and it runs, the real Bilderberg's Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday. Well, really on Monday sometimes. Why?
Go ahead.
Why? What triggered the police? Because I know this happened in Austria last year, too. Is it fair to say the worst police we've seen are in Germany and Austria? Because, I mean, we would report if somebody did something for the police to respond. But from what I heard from Paul, no one's doing anything. People are polite. They're, like, threatening to arrest or arresting British tourists. I mean, British tourists are stereotypically the nicest people on the planet.
Yeah, and those people were, and they saw what happened last night, so they knew what I think what they were getting into when they did their little protest. But basically, it just said, "What have you?" Their sign said, "What have you had to hide?" And the other sign said, "This will get confiscated." Prophetic, because it did get confiscated, and we've got that video coming out. We shot it in many parts because it was kind of a long situation.
So there's photos up in the story at drudgereport.com. The photos are there.
Okay, good, good. And you know, it's just amazing the way we're being treated. And last night, while we were getting harassed by the police, the 20 or so police that harassed us.
Was there any trigger? I mean, because they looked hateful. They just looked like they hated you.
Well, at some point, they got really mad at my light. I turned on a video light because it was pitch black almost. And, you know, I like to shoot good video. So I turned on a light. And then one guy just started going off. And I could tell what he was mad at through the broken German that I speak. And, and then our translator, who also seemed to be pro-migrant, said, he doesn't like your light. Could you turn it off? And but they thoroughly searched my bag. They went through every pocket, pulled out every little thing. They pulled out the safety pins. I had safety pins in a little pocket.
Germans checked your papers and searched everything thoroughly? No.
Yeah, they did. They were very thorough. And they were marveling at the tools that I had. I have all these little tools for things. And, oh, a little tool. And I'm like, yeah, I use a lot of tools. I'm kind of German like you guys. And but it was surreal because we really got five steps away from this restaurant and then they were on us. Then the van started pulling up, more vans started pulling up. And it was how they went after the two cardboard protesters, the cardboard sign protesters. They surround, like four were just standing there kind of stalking them. And then they all came at once. And one guy, you could tell he was, I think, learning how to be a tyrannical police officer, started reading from the guidebook. You know, Dresden makes law where you cannot have sign here, but you could have a sign over here. So they were speaking English to the English speakers. And it was just very interesting to watch that go on. And Josh shot some good footage from up top. I shot some footage of it. We're going to be putting that up. So people,
by the way, notice there's not a lot of tall buildings in Dresden. That's because, 500,000 people got killed in one night in a famous bombing. That was supposedly a children's city off limits. They had an agreement with England. But right. To get Hitler mad, to shift gears and stop bombing military bases, they sent in RAF raids to bomb civilian targets. And Hitler took the bait and lost World War II because of it. Dresden was a key turning point.
Correct. And when we were in the Pegida protest, there's a little marker where the first bomb fell. So they make a little, it fell in the square there, and they made a little.
Well, the Germans already followed a globalist project once. I mean, the euro is a Nazi project. So here they are helping continue a real Nazi project that'll destroy their own families and collapse Germany. And they don't care because the cops, you know, think they're God. It's a perfect example of compartmentalization.
Yeah, that's correct. And that's what they said. We don't make these rules up. We're just following orders.
Next time, bring up Nuremberg Code. I declare Nuremberg.
If people brought that up while this was going on, somebody said, that's something from Nuremberg. That's from Nuremberg. And that's exactly what it was. And last night, I got mad after a while. It takes me a while, but once I get mad, I start like spouting off. And I started spouting off, well, if I was a Syrian migrant, you guys would be kissing my ass and giving me a home and food and all this money. You wouldn't be treating me like this. And I don't know if that pissed them off or not. They didn't really answer me. But today I talked to a few of them. I talked to a guy who'd been to California. He'd heard my accent and wanted to know where I was from. And we talked for a while, and he's working on a sergeant. But, you know, these people are essentially, I told him, I said, the reason people don't like you and they're disrespecting you is because you're protecting criminals. And that's the bottom line. And you could say, well, they're not criminals. They're criminals. These people are criminals. They work above the law. They think the law doesn't affect them.
That's right, and following their orders doesn't protect you. I mean, plus your peaceful press.
Yeah, exactly.
Look, they're arresting Germans all over the country that try to protest the open borders. The German government works for globalists and is a outside occupying group taking you over. Do you understand that? Comprende. Sprechen Sie Deutsch.
And that's what we've been telling people about, the people that have been walking up talking to us. Paul had an interesting debate with a lady who was from England talking about the Brexit. And she was older, and she's worried about her pension. That's why she's going to vote to stay in.
They always hold you hostage. You know, give us a bailout or we'll implode you, when they're the ones screwing you over. Iceland kicked the bankers out. It's doing great now.
And people don't realize there's not going to be a pension. By the time the pension's gone, they're using the pension in Germany to pay for the migrants. Okay? And these police get out. They on the side of the police cars, it says, come with us for a great job. They think they're going to get a pension. It's gone, buddy.
No, they'll all find out. I mean, just like when 20 million Germans got killed in World War II, following orders is going to get you in a really bad position, and I just feel sorry for them. Well, listen, huge success, man. InfoWars videos and reports are all over the news. Top story on DrudgeReport.com. Global government's being openly discussed. Mainstream media is admitting they want global government. They want internet taxes. They want internet IDs. They hate Donald Trump. I mean, I've never seen such success. I've kind of gotten jaded to a certain point because we were having such success, but thank God. Thank you, guys. Thank everybody involved. I just can't wait the next few days to see what else happens as you guys file reports constantly to InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com and as DrudgeReport.com and others pick it up. But I keep doing Drudge credit because when we cover it, a lot of folks see it on the internet, millions read it, it's successful. When Drudge picks it up, everybody looks at Drudge, not just libertarians and patriots, and then it forces the media to cover it. It's just a huge deal, dude. I mean, top story on Drudge.
Yeah, no, and that wakes up more people. More people go, wow, what is Bilderberg? And then they start thinking about it and go, wait a minute, a secret group gets together from Western Europe and Canada and the United States, and they have these meetings, and a lot of these people run giant capital firms.
Decide on ends up being the agenda the next year. I mean, this is important.
Exactly, yeah. And you know Lindsey Graham's here to try to figure out how they're going to stop Donald Trump. That he's instrumental in stopping Trump, okay? I don't think people understand the gravity.
CNBC now admits that. They admit from their sources, our sources are correct. That's why this is important. Well, listen, get back in there. Keep getting your articles up. You can add more to the Drudge Report article. You know, as it develops, obviously, the video of those folks actually getting harassed, their signs being taken. But I mean, imagine the German police working for foreign multinationals and Nazi war criminals are there harassing the press. This is truly despicable. And I believe it's a crime against humanity and a crime against free speech worldwide. Merkel is a tyrant and is the second coming of Hitler. All right, Alex Jones here back live. Let me shift gears into what's happening here domestically. This first clip, of course, is Jamie Foxx a few years ago saying Barack Obama is the Lord and Savior. And then we've got a clip of the media basically telling everybody that we must recognize this is historical, that she's a woman. Total gimmick. No, she's a criminal. It doesn't matter what her race or what sex. You can't make us bow down to her because she's a woman and use this gimmick. Then we cut to a minute and a half of her being accepted and her coming out on stage as a goddess. If you're not a radio listener, you got to go to InfoWars.com/show to look at the video. A huge Joker smile, Princess Leia goddess outfit, like she's being worshipped, and then they blur everything like she's on fire. I mean, this is ritualistic. This is bizarre. This is them trying to set her up like a dictator. I mean, what a freak show. So let's go to that first clip.
And our Lord and Savior, Barack Obama.
Now, here they are introducing our new Lord and Savior with a unified across the media from Fox News to CNN, the same talking point. Here it is.
Did you hear it? It's the sound of that glass ceiling breaking, no matter what side of the political aisle you're on.
It's an incredible and a historic moment, again, no matter your politics.
And I think we can all admit, no matter what your politics are in this situation, no matter who you support, this is a very historic moment.
Adam, no matter what your politics, this is a historic moment.
Regardless of your politics, this is a historic moment.
You know, with all the back and forth over Sanders and Clinton and Trump and everything on the Republican
Republican side, can we just take a second to stop and recognize history?
Regardless of where you stand politically, tonight is a very special night for women in this country.
And some residents this morning are saying that regardless of politics, they are proud that their local girl has made history.
Whatever your politics are, we need to mark this moment in American history.
Well, however you feel about Hillary Clinton, she claimed her place in history.
No matter what side of the aisle you're on, there's no denying Hillary Clinton has made history.
Whatever you think about Hillary Clinton, whatever you think about her politics, an important moment for the nation.
Now, that's enough. Just turn it off, please. That's the Washington Free Beacon doing a great job there. So, with that compilation, what we're seeing here is total brainwashing. That was simultaneously, as it happened, they had that all pre-written, ready to push that this is for women. Yeah, how's that multi-thousand percentage point increase in breast cancer doing for you in the West? Oh, it's a historic day for women. How's all the infertility doing for you? How's the extra work hours be treated like trash working for you? Because the whole women's movement the last 80 years has been run by Eva Bernays and then the CIA. Doesn't mean we shouldn't try to look at the roles of men and women in society, but they're getting rid of roles for humans, and the machines are coming. Now, let's now look at a compilation of Hillary coming out on stage and being worshipped and then leaning back in a Princess Leia outfit and CNN blurring the footage, and then CNN came out and called her a god and a goddess who was being worshipped. I mean, these are quotes. It doesn't get any more freakazoid than this. And then she's got a big rubber head with a giant jack-o'-lantern face. Her face could be a horror movie cover. I'm not kidding. She could be a Saw cover. I'm going to call Mark Berg up and say you should make her the new star. I mean, a big rubber-headed psychopath demon. Cult leader. Let's go ahead and roll the footage. I'm going to be describing this for radio listeners.
Time in our nation's history that a woman will be a major party's nominee.
And she talks like a robot. Had plenty of women as queens and dictators and elected.
No mistake. Senator Sanders, his campaign, and the vigorous debate that we've had about how to raise incomes, reduce.
By the way, they stole the election from him.
Increase.
Nobody cares. It's okay.
Have been very good for the Democratic Party and for America.
Oh, the Democratic Party comes first.
Trump is temperamentally unfit to be president. Stoking fear and rubbing salt in wounds and reminding us daily just how great he is. He says, let's make America great again. That is code for let's take America backwards.
No, it means have better trade deals, witch.
Tonight's victory.
Look at these idiots behind her.
About one person.
Oh, that's good. Now let's show the footage then when CNN warps it and turns her into the goddess as we go out to break, and she's doing bizarre Joker faces and then being worshipped by this pack of morons.
Extinguishing her first trailblazing campaign.
Her trailblazing campaign.
Triumph in her long Democratic primary.
Oh, look at her. Oh, the goddess.
Exactly 8 years after extinguishing her first trailblazing campaign.
Look at that Jezebel smile. We'll be right back. Stay with us. We're seeing reporters arrested, people harassed, British tourists with signs saying what's happening in the building being detained, their bags ransacked, their signs and property stolen. I tell you, this is really a frightening time to see the tyranny that is unfolding all across the world when you attempt to expose globalists and their corporate operations to establish a private corporate planetary government. The good news is Infowars.com and our breakdown of this is the top story on Drudge, and right above it, in the same block, is mainstream newspapers and publications from the UK to the US admitting, okay, they're setting up world government. Okay, they want to shut down free speech. Okay, they want to shut down Donald Trump. World planners meet in secret to discuss the British exit. Migrants, Trump on the menu, reporters chased away, and worse. And that is the biggest link on the internet right there. So it's being forced out in the open. That is so exciting. And somebody's been helping do that for years is Charlie Skelton, the London Guardian. He was somewhat of a critic of it, I don't know, 7, 8 years ago, whenever it was. We went to Turkey, and then they arrested him and took his stuff and treated him like crap over and over. And he went, wow, this really is tyrannical. So he's gone from being somewhat of a comedic journalist who was very popular, to being more serious on that, at least on that subject. We're going to talk to him here in about a minute and a half. Before we go any further here today, we have a great sponsor, SolutionsFromScience.com, and they've been sponsors of ours for close to 10 years, and they only come around every once in a while, though, when they've got something really special. The Pocket Power X, a new pocket-sized device, lets you create your own personal micro power grid. It's an amazing system, and they've got a whole bunch of other great survival systems. But forget survival system. It's good to just start moving off the grid, even if it starts slowly. This is the great unit to start with. But for all your survival needs, you name it, they've got them at solutionsfromscience.com. You can find a wide variety of preparedness products, from solar power generators, survival gear, and fertilizers. They're all available right now and great pricing from Solutions from Science website, solutionsfromscience.com, or give them a call, 877-327-0365. That's solutionsfromscience.com. And then briefly, we only had it once. We only had it one time. We've got like 20 products now on InfoWarsLife.com. We just get the top scientists, top researchers, bringing the very best organic, clean, triple-tested products. And Living Defense is harmful organism cleansing. 120 big horse capsules. They're powder form, so you absorb them. What is it? So it's like 30 different herbs and compounds that are known to knock out parasites just across the board. A lot of these things have been used for thousands of years to knock out parasites. Some of these are, you know, the latest developments in cleanly doing it. And this thing was such a sleeper. It sold out in 2 days. It's taken us 6 months to get all these ingredients again, have them all tested, have them all be organic, have them all be at California standards. That's meant to be impossible. And when you purchase it, it funds the operation. So for yourself, your children, you name it, it's all seen as, you know, healthy and safe to do. But always check with your physician, because who knows what other situations you may personally have. It's discounted, even though it's a product we sell out of. Normally $44, it's $34 right now. It's almost got 5 stars and third-party review sites that we have linked. InfoWarsLife.com, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And I'm very, very excited that we got triple the amount we got 6 months ago, but that'll probably still sell out in a couple weeks. That's a good problem to have, but it's very expensive to be able to send, you know, 3 reporters to Germany and sent, you know, 5 reporters the last week to California to cover the primaries. We're having a big effect, but it's very expensive. So thank you for buying the Hillary for Prison shirts, the Molon Labe shirts, you know, genetic roulette books and videos on how dangerous GMO is. People say, are you liberal or conservative? I'm just a populist, common sense. You got a bunch of world government people meeting in secret. They're acting like reporters of the criminals. And I'm just proud of my crew and others having the courage to be out there. Now, speaking of courage, Charlie Skelton has a lot of courage, because they target him, I've got to say, 6, 7, I don't know, time flies, years that he's been covering Bilderberg, because he's with probably the biggest newspaper arguably in the world. It's not even the New York Times. All over Europe, it's the big English, you know, language paper folks read. And he's able to actually cover it. The Guardian lets him cover real issues, because they know that's how you remain credible, in my view. And so the police and governmental people know that he's, you know, high-powered. And I'm kind of speaking for him. I haven't had private conversations with him on this, so I've been at Bilderberg three or four times with him. He's a great guy, he and his wife. But am I correct in saying they target you, Charlie? I know you didn't come on about this today. You came on to tell us about what you witnessed the last few days, and as Bilderberg officially kicked off, it just seems like every year, and my crew was saying this, they seem to target you, detain you, arrest you, raid your hotel rooms, harass you, try to get your rental cars taken away. I mean, is that an accurate statement, and why are they coming after you if it is an accurate statement?
Well, first of all, hello, Alex. It's lovely to be here.
Good to have you.
You're looking well, looking very smart. Well, this year hasn't been as bad as last year, I have to say. Last year was pretty bad. The Austrian police were pretty tough. But this year, the German police, you know, there's not much dialogue going on. And yes, we were held up for, you know, 3/4 of an hour last night, you know, with the usual checks and this, that, and the other. And I, to be honest, there have been other people this year who've had it worse. So, you know, which I have to say I'm glad about on a purely selfish basis. I think you have to say the story this year for me is the number of politicians that have come. It's a very, very political summit. And, you know, people don't realize that it's you know, a lot of people, I don't know what they think it is, but when you look at the sheer number of politicians here, you have to treat it as a political summit. I mean, three members of the German cabinet here, you know, two prime ministers, and, you know, four finance ministers, including the Canadian finance minister. And there's a, it's a high-level political summit, but one that's thrown by, you know, Deutsche Bank and Airbus. You know, it's a lobbying junket, a big, intense one that all of these people come to. That's as you say, it's a globalist operation. I mean, it very definitely is.
Break down from your perspective how Bilderberg is changing, because you talk about they're still powerful, but they're a little more paranoid.
Well, one of the I think with the Brexit, the whole Brexit debate is something that concerns them, because for various reasons it would completely unplug the whole TTIP trade deal, but worse than that, it would fragment this building block of the European Union, which is part of their, when I say they, I mean the kind globalists. Ideologues of that particular ilk, it would be a dangerous fracture of that kind of free trade and political bloc. And they talk about the serious consequences and the dangers. A lot of the people here in Dresden have spoken out. For example, Henri de Castries is the chairman of Bilderberg. You know, he talks about the serious consequences of Brexit. A lot of them do. Thomas Enders, the head of Airbus, who's pretty much playing host here, he's talked about lobbying for Brexit, against Brexit for the Remain people, and the Remain campaign has had money from Goldman Sachs and JP Morgan. Goldman Sachs, you know, I've had a conversation myself with a director of Goldman Sachs. He was having a glass of wine last night, and I went up and said hello. I said, would you mind having a press conference? That would be nice. And he said he'd pass it on. So whether or not he will, I hope he does.
Well, let's remember Charlie Skelton, again, the London Guardian, that just 5, 6, 7 years ago, some mainstream media was saying Bilderberg didn't exist. So yeah, this is a huge victory for independent real press that now at least they admit it exists. And that to a great extent, it is as important as Davos. It's just basically a private Davos that predates Davos. I mean, that's how I put it.
Absolutely. And I think if you look at the press, you can see there's a definite change. You know, year by year, you get more pieces in the mainstream press that treat it seriously, more pieces that do an analysis of the list, that the participant list, that look at it as a kind of political, commercial, private summit, that critique it in terms of transparency and lobbying. And that the language, I think, is changing, and it's veering away from a kind of easy description of it as a conspiracy theory or something, which you still get, but you get less of, and more simply journalists treating it for what it is, which is an extremely high-powered, commercially paid-for globalist summit. So, yes, I think there's a change from the point of view of the media for the good. And in terms of Bilderberg itself, I think it's fascinating to see how over the last few years they have shifted towards Silicon Valley and towards new technology. You know, the people that you see on their board of on the steering committee are people like Eric Schmidt from Google and Peter Thiel, who's on the board of Facebook. And they've just brought in Alex Karp, who runs Palantir, which is chaired by Peter Thiel, which is the big kind of data mining and data analysis company, which was set up with CIA money. And in fact, they're bringing in Google DeepMind people like Dennis Hassabitz, who runs Google DeepMind. And they've got someone who's the co-chairman of OpenAI. So artificial intelligence and data mining and data analysis and big data, that's been a theme for the last few years. So what you can see is that Bilderberg is not really this old fuddy-duddy group of people. You know,
they're passing the baton on to the technocrats. Yeah, exactly. And I'm glad you raised this. Because you talk about they want to be in the future, but they're obsessed in the past with one of your headlines earlier this week. So let's talk about that. They admit they want a technocracy. They call themselves technocrats, unelected. They're going to decide. They're going to feed us what data they want. They're going to control the future. These are all statements. They're handing the baton to the Zuckerbergs and the Schmidts of the world. who were there. So we really see the old guard, like the Skeksis, collapsing into dust, handing the scepters. I mean, is that an accurate way to basically boil this down?
Yeah, I wouldn't say they, you know, some of them fade away, but, you know, Kissinger is still here. He's 93. I just saw him arrive. If you look at some of the older guard, people like Jacob Wallenberg, they run huge industrial conglomerates. And they're still extremely powerful. A lot of these are families, like the Wallenberg family.
Oh, of course they're powerful. I'm just saying they're betting everything on technocracy and kind of handing the control over to the technocrats.
They're definitely betting on technology and technocracy. I mean, without a doubt. Because apart from anything else, they're not idiots. They, you know, they're smart people and they want to be smart. But, you know, because being smart for them means keeping, I would say, in control is perhaps...
Sure, sure. Why do you think they wanted to keep it secret for over 50 years? And what do you think they think of failing now?
It's an odd one, isn't it? I think they have... They've pushed the media away for so long that the mainstream media got out of the habit of speaking about Bilderberg. They sort of forgot that it existed. Then became a little bit of an embarrassment almost because, and it is an embarrassment, to be quite honest, it is embarrassing that the mainstream media still, to a large degree, don't turn up. But, you know, they're still writing about it. And I tell you what's a really good sign is that the agencies are here. So we've got Getty Images and we've got Reuters who are here taking photographs and feeding them into the kind of press pool of stuff that floats around. So at least the newspapers that can't quite be bothered to come here can at least take the photographs and then write around it. So, you know, it's changing for the good. And, you know, the more everyone like you and Luke Radowski and Dan Dix and everyone who comes and talks about it, everyone that keeps the subject ticking over and in the public consciousness and in the media consciousness, all of that is hugely important because absolutely. They clearly don't like publicity. And in fact, what's interesting is that this hotel that's at this year has got two entrances. And all of the politicians, with I think about one exception, have come in the blocked out limos and they've been swept into the back door, down into the underground garage with no chance of being photographed. And, you know, it's been the industrialists and the financiers that have come in the front door because they kind of don't care. You know, in an age where politicians talk so easily about transparency, it's kind of pathetic.
That's right.
Very senior politicians are hiding like this.
And I think what you hit on, Mr. Skelton, again, the London Guardian, is so key. Charlie Skelton joining us, theguardian.com, is that politicians have always denied this even exists, or that Tony Blair or Bill Clinton got vetted there, or Hillary got vetted there, or Obama got vetted there. I mean, I was there. I saw the Secret Service drive in. They aimed MP5 heckler, you know, machine guns at me. I got it on tape, you know, and they still said, didn't happen, New York Times. It's just such a collapse of the facade. But you point out the political class looking at the list. They always try to stay off the list. But more and more, as you pointed out this year, it appears to be almost purely political. Normally, it's all about big business deals or if there's about to be a new war, a bunch of generals or some of the Saudis are there. Now the Chinese are hardly ever there, showing they've been kind of kicked out of things. So you can really see this is so political. What do you think is behind that from your sources or just your resource? I mean, is it trying to keep Britain in the euro? Is it because of Europe and so much trouble with the migrant thing? I mean, what do you think makes this so political this year instead of just managing, you know, the next political move? It seems, what does it signify to have so many politicians there?
Well, I think it signifies to me that the power base of Bilderberg, which is broadly speaking one of transnational banks and oil companies and industrial conglomerates, so Shell Oil, BP, Goldman Sachs, HSBC, these giant financial entities clearly want to keep their consensus going. They want to keep their worldview in play.
So that means that they've got a lot of politicians there. They may be having trouble keeping everybody in line. Or maybe they're trying to make sure they follow the plan exactly, or what is it?
I mean, you know, at one level, who knows? Because, you know, we don't get to the politicians that come don't generally report back on it. And, you know, for example, our Chancellor of the Exchequer, George Osborne, goes regularly. He's not here this year, but he does regularly go. And he reports back in his transparency data, and I use the phrase advisedly, with the phrase general discussion. That's all he admits happened at the at Bilderberg, general discussion. It's a bit like when you look at their list of topics and they have current events. You know, that isn't telling us anything. And it's kind of a slap in the face for anyone that values.
Sure. Remember Watford 4 years ago? They were denying the prime minister was going. Or was it three? And then here he comes, you know, riding straight in.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Tony Blair lied to Parliament about going and then was caught on camera by Luke Radowski, actually, who put him on the spot. And he went, oh, yes, actually, it was a very useful meeting. Yes, I was there in 1993. Now, that's years after having lied to Parliament about going. I mean, I'm hoping, you know, I live in hope, that the more attention, the more chipping away we do at this story, the more we can hold it in the kind of media and public consciousness so that politicians will just be more inclined to behave like adults and behave like, you know, representative democracy, you know, representative.
Exactly. And transparency is going to make them act better. That's why they don't want transparency.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, that is it. Transparency puts them on the spot and it holds them to account. You know, the last thing a politician wants is to be held to account.
Charlie Skelton is our guest at TheGuardian.com. We got one more short segment with him, and the fourth hour starts with Anthony Gucciardi coming in. When we come back, I want to just let you talk about whatever you think is most important instead of me asking questions, but also get into what else do you think is on the agenda that's not on this list? What does this list that they put out tell you about what's coming up? Charlie Skelton with the London Guardian, one of the first, if not the first, big international publications to even admit Bilderberg existed, okay? And again, a lot of that is so much because Drudge, about a decade ago, began to link to our articles at Infowars.com. This isn't about credit here, but it's about realizing the evolution of awakening and that we're winning. All right, we're going to shift gears to domestic politics, the economy, and more with Anthony Gucciardi in the next hour. I'm going to ride shotgun into the next hour with him, and Anthony will also be opening the phones up. Charlie Skelton's our guest. Okay, Charlie Skelton of The Guardian over in Dresden, Germany, covering what's happening. I think we agree, unprecedented coverage, unprecedented admissions that big decisions are being made there. What else is on your radar screen right now?
Well, I would say that it's a statement made by the chairman of Bilderberg, Henri de Castries, who's the guy tipped to be the new head of HSBC, one of the world's largest banks. He was asked recently at an interview, does privacy exist? No. He was asked, is privacy dead? That's right. He was asked, is privacy dead? And he looked at the guy and he went, yes. And what's very interesting is that I'm talking about some of the elites here at Bilderberg, treat privacy as something which has kind of, for most of us, evaporated. And yet, for them, we only have to look out the window and see the rows and rows of police vans and the concrete walls. Privacy is absolutely alive and well and thriving at Bilderberg. But for us, you know, they have people like Alex Karp, as I said, from Palantir, who's job is one of the world's largest private companies. Their software is designed to crunch our data that we're freely just spouting out in every which way.
And create algorithms.
Exactly. So you've got a board member of Facebook here, Peter Thiel. You know, this is, it's all about, and, you know, and obviously Eric Schmidt from Google. So
that's a great point. Schmidt makes his girlfriends wear hoods over their heads. Zuckerberg's buying up his whole neighborhood so nobody can look at him. They're obsessed with secrecy and have the police harassing the press. And then they're all spying on us.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. I mean, but worse than spying on us, they think it's dead. They think that the argument is over. They think, you know, when I say they, if I'm quoting the chairman of Bilderberg, I think it's fair enough to say they. He thinks, at least, that privacy is dead. It's over. So we're living in a world, a post-privacy world. And this is
so they're killing our privacy, using our data against it, and then giving themselves like royalty exemption from it.
Absolutely, and it's a very technocratic structure. If you think about it, you know, it's like Soviet Russia. There's the elite, or East Germany. You know, it's the elite who know everything, and the rest of us who get spied on. And you know, the difference is, in West Germany, a guy had to sit there listening at the keyhole or whatever. And here we're just throwing open our lives to data crunching companies.
Sure, like, and I know on German TV, because I follow it some, they have all these shows about the Stasi and how bad it was and who, and then they admit it's like hundreds of times worse now. And it's like, oh, it's okay.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, it's an argument I think that needs to be reignited.
No, you always have the best arguments. I mean, you're absolutely right. They're total hypocrites.
Totally. And, you know, and it's kind of annoying that, you know, we talk about transparency. You know, politicians are meant to be transparent, and yet structures like political structures like Bilderberg carry on as totally happily as ever, and just as powerful, if not more, than ever. So, it's a kind of a slightly...
And they use all their inside data, they admit, to game the markets, to rig the stock markets, the currency. They admit just everything's rigged. They take all our data, they screw us over, and then our taxes pay to have paramilitary police harass the press.
Yeah, absolutely. And you look at they will engage in things like LIBOR fraud and a lot of banking fraud. And they, you know, the guy who, well, anyway, there's people here who've been implicated in these things. There's definitely a kind of one rule for one, lots of rules for the rest
of
us.
Well, I'm glad you're there, Charlie Skelton, covering. And hopefully before you leave or on Monday in the aftermath or so, we could have you pop back in. Folks, and go to The Guardian, just type in Charlie Skelton or Bilderberg. You'll find his reportage. Are there other good ways to follow you on Twitter, Facebook, or how?
Yeah, I'm tweeting from Deyouk, DeYouk, Deyouk. That's on Twitter. But also, there's quite a lot of information on bilderbergmeetings.co.uk. So a lot of background stuff there for people that are interested.
Be safe, and we'll talk to you very, very soon. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Alex.
Thank you. We'll be back in the fourth hour. A lot of stations cover it, some don't. Infowars.com/show. I'll be co-hosting with Anthony. We're getting back into what's happening locally when we return. Why do I have bumper music I love so much? Because I have to start talking about it every time it comes in. That's all part of the celebration of humanity. Hey, when Willie Nelson goes, he's like 83 now. I got to know him back when he was like 74, 75, 76, 77. Last time I ever saw him, had dinner with him and Dave Mustaine. They were there. I was with Dave Mustaine and ran into Willie Nelson and ended up having dinner with him, and he was like already 80. And I'm just digressing. You actually go to Twitter. We actually sent a photo out of that. He's a real character behind the scenes. Oh, boy. He really liked the film Endgame. That's why he came to see it. Tell you. Back in 2007, I was sitting there, and I hear Willie Nelson's here. Willie Nelson's here in the packed crowd. Like, it was only 300 in the theater, but that's a theater of 300. I was assigned DVDs, and all of a sudden, he just walks around the corner in the counter and just grabs my hand and goes, "I really like your movie." And I go, "Well, here's my phone number. I'd like to get you on." And he goes, "Okay." And about 6 months later, called me up. Pretty crazy. I'm not name dropping. It's just you like hear Willie Nelson, you go, "Oh, I've been friends with him." His wife's a big Democrat, I think like his fifth wife. She's a nice lady. But, man, Willie Nelson gives you a call and wants you to come play chess with him. He invited me to go to Hawaii with him and Woody Harrelson literally for a week one time on the private jet. I didn't have time. I said, "Willie, I just don't have time." He goes, "We're going to have fun, play dominoes, and smoke the vape." And I'm not really a pot smoker, but, when you're with Willie, you smoke pot so you can't walk. And that's the only problem about it. I can tell. I'm going to stop right there. I'm going to stop at that story. Okay, I can't tell it. There's too many good ones. There's too many good ones about hanging out with Jesse Ventura and Willie Nelson, too. That's a really good story. Hung out with those two together a few times. I didn't mean to digress off into Hollywood. I don't care about Hollywood. I don't care about, but if I like an artist, like a musician or a painter, or an architect, or a writer, or a researcher, I love them. But who I really love are people that have courage. And that's why I love Donald Trump, despite the fact I disagree with some of the things he's done. The whole power structure is after him and lying about him and saying he hates Mexicans because they took it out of context where he goes, "This judge is a Mexican. I admire him that he's a nationalist and cares about his country and his people, but he's not an American." And they said, "Oh, because he's not, what, Anglo?" No, that's not what he said. The judge is in two La Raza groups, and his group boycotts Trump. Look, if you want to be a member of La Raza, that's your business. I'm not a member of the KKK. And I don't care if people in La Raza go, and I know a lot of folks listening, you probably had a mom or dad that was in it. You're in college, they say you've been oppressed, I'm sure somebody did something to you wrong. That's how the world works. And then, hey, you're going to be part of the Chicano studies, and it's all funded by the CIA and the rest of it. And it's just meant to absolutely sit there and put a chip on your shoulder. I grew up in Dallas, Texas, okay? And I had rednecks and black people constantly starting fights with me just because they were looking for a fight. And I did have fights with Mexicans, too, but the least amount. And the Mexicans all know that. They know gringos, on average, are leaving people alone. They'll try to marry you or try to go, eat at your restaurant, but It's just all made up. And Donald Trump is not racist, and it's a load of bull. We're going to talk about it when we come back. Again, I cannot stress enough, even though I don't want the attention, how awesome this crew is for InfoWars Live, how awesome the InfoWars Nightly News crew is, how awesome the entire InfoWars family is, how awesome John Harmon is up at GCNLive.com and Ted Anderson. All of our sponsors, our affiliates, you the listeners, numero uno when it comes to temporal issues, and then, of course, God, who is all-encompassing. I am just here to tell you, I am dedicated to doing the best job I can do. Lord knows sometimes it's a train wreck. I am dedicated to telling you the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. And that's just what it comes down to. And we're doing the best we can. What matters is intent. The globalists are out to get us. Now, coming up at the bottom of the hour, Anthony Gucciardi has requested that they air an 11-minute boil down of the last time Drudge was here in town. Crazy, because I guess great minds think alike, or minds that want to be free think alike. I requested like a 3-minute boil down a few days ago from one of the editors. I didn't know he'd already done this for an 11-minute clip. He's going to be airing that because it's just everything he talked about is now happening. And it's just, it's important because 9 times out of 10, it's Drudge alone who ends up taking topics that no one else would put in the mainstream media and forcing it out. The Pentagon says they can't stand it. And really, it's indicative of the death of the mainstream media. And you can really say the facade's fully collapsing now. We're reaching a point where it's got more holes than Swiss cheese, a 6% trust rate in AP polls. But separately, I try to do the best job I can. Occasionally, I get a wild hair. I was about to go get my hair cut at like 3 o'clock yesterday and then come back to the office. And I just had a wild idea. And I decided to, and we're going to air this a little bit later. Anthony's going to air it, but it's up on InfoWars.com. And I had this idea because I was looking at Drudge and I was watching the super clip cut, which we can roll behind me if you guys want, of Hillary on CNN leaning back in a goddess outfit like Princess Leia being worshipped. And even CNN said she's a god. She's a golden god is the quote. History-making golden god. And it was the weird Joker face she then flashed like a demon. I mean, I would put this in an Exorcist movie where a demon-possessed woman becomes president. I mean, this is Hollywood-level scary-looking woman. I mean, she's super evil, super creepy, has the bones to prove it, the whole background, starts like having an orgasm on stage and then just acting totally freakish. And since I attacked this yesterday, not even the leftist groups have attacked me back. They normally do because they know it's frickin' cult level. I mean, this is out of control. So here's just a short excerpt of it.
Stop.
Don't show it yet. Don't show Jakari taking me down. That's coming up at the bottom of the hour, ladies and gentlemen. That's good. Let's stop right there. Oh, my gosh. And it all depends on a lot of people say, man, you look really skinny in some photos, and you look a little bit chubby in those. Well, I mean, when Jakari's holding you back with his arm around your neck, because we did it. It's a skit. It's fun. It's obvious it's a skit. It doesn't cut to a clip with, it's obviously fake, like the Hitler dog video, okay? I hope we don't get arrested for it. Pointing out that I'm suddenly worshiping Hillary and have joined the cult and I'm under her spell. And what's the name of the video up on InfoWars? It's Alex Jones loses it, has to be restrained by a reporter. There it is. Alex Jones flips out, is physically restrained. But I still lost a lot of weight there. But when you're wearing, you know, tight 36 jeans, I should be wearing 38. Looks like I left a little bit of love handles. But, man, I got like 10 pounds to go. And I'm a mesomorph, folks. I have the body of a gorilla. I'm not an endomorph or an ectomorph, okay? I have, like, thighs that big around when I don't even work out. But I have lost a ton of weight. But I don't mean to digress off into that. It's just that I've been not drinking beer for a week or so, so I'm going to lose even more weight now. But I don't even know where I'm going with all this. Just Anthony Gucciardi, we've got to have some fun. But I really want to ask the audience. I don't do a lot of comedy. Whatever I do, people say, oh, he's trying to fake us, when it's obviously satire. It was like, Jakari this morning was like, yeah, I don't get it. A few years ago, they said ISIS is going to assassinate Dumbo as a hoax. I think it was The Onion. And he goes, people said, oh, my God, I hope they don't kill Dumbo. Or why did you hoax us saying they wanted to kill Dumbo? It's obvious. You don't have to say satire on a 1940s Disney character named Dumbo. It doesn't exist. There is no flying elephant with giant pink ears. There is a crazy Texan with the body of a gorilla ripping his shirt off, going Hulk style, which I didn't intend to do. Jakari kind of too quick, because we only scripted it like in 30 seconds. I said, get over here with a camera, say you're shooting a gun piece. Buckley runs in, run down the hall, you'll see what I'm doing. Jakari's like, okay. And I just said, restrain me. And so in one take, we shot this whole thing in like 2 minutes of preparation. It was insane. I love doing, like, there's a bubble gun piece we did where I just said, hey, they're banning bubble guns. They're arresting kids that have bubble guns. My Little Kitty or Hello Kitty or whatever it is. Yeah, it's Hello Kitty from Japan. So I said, we're going to be in this board meeting. I'm going to pull a bubble gun out, and then you're going to freak out and stop me. And that was no preparation there either. So we're going to rear a bubble gun today if we have time as well. But I tell you, I'm a little bit euphoric here with Paul Watson and the rest of the crew and Drudge and everything that's happening, how global government is absolutely getting a new you-know-what torn in it. I mean, I know victory when I see it, and I think we've almost reached a champagne-level event here. Anthony Gucciardi.
You know, you talk about people thinking that satire is real. It's because we live in a headline society. People can't actually process things for themselves anymore, and they just read the insane mainstream media. It looks like The Onion anyway. You go on the mainstream media, it's the most ridiculous stuff you could possibly imagine. So they don't even think now, oh, that could be satire because everything's so insane anyway. It's like already weird and already projected onto you. And they just read the headlines and no one looks at the details.
Yeah, I guess that's it. I mean, Jakari's laughing in the background. I'm ripping my shirt off. It's obviously a joke.
It's obviously a joke. I watched it yesterday, by the way. It's really funny. I do want to play it on here.
Well, I mean, be honest with me. I think it's okay. Jakari did a great job, and I'm not
saying
that.
Real.
He did a great job.
I think it's real. Let me just put it out there. I think you're obviously a closeted Hillary Clinton supporter.
You caught me worshiping her?
You were caught worshiping her. Actually, we shouldn't have said all that. It's real, ladies and gentlemen. He was caught worshiping Hillary. You have to see the video. I'm actually more impressed by the fact that you ripped the shirt off. And, Hulk Hogan had to get those stretchy shirts to rip off. They had to make them custom for him so he could rip them off.
Is that true?
It's true. Yeah, Hulk Hogan has shirts that were custom.
Is it really hard to rip a shirt off?
I've never done it, but it seems pretty hard to me, yeah. Seems pretty hard.
I remember I tried pulling for a minute. It wasn't
coming off. I saw you just ripped it, though. You just got mad at it.
That's so powerful. No, come on. It's not that hard.
I don't know. We'll have to try it.
Well, they actually are thick quality shirts, and it was a little bit harder than some of the other shirts.
Yeah, we saved the shirt,
ripped off in video.
We saved that
fun
shirt.
I am ripping off Hulk Hogan, and I'm ripping off, who am I ripping off right now? Ladies and gentlemen, folks, we've got coming up. Tell us what you've got coming up today, Anthony Gucciardi.
Well, one of the weirdest things that no one seems to be doing anything about, because it's a headline society and this is too complex, we're all guilty of it though, is Oklahoma police, you've talked about this a little bit, but they can seize your entire bank account on a traffic stop without any charges.
No drugs, no nothing, no arrest, nothing. Just going to suck the money out of your bank account.
But it's not just Oklahoma, so we're going to talk about that. They can pull you over, and they could just say, oh, for nothing.
We should do a man on the street about this. We should do a man on the street about this.
It is insane. They get millions of dollars in funding from this. And there's some groups that are talking about it, but I've not heard any of the news program. And there could be, I just haven't heard it, talk about this in depth like this. They are taking money from people for doing nothing wrong. And what's sad is, and what I want to talk about, is I like the police. I think, I was looking at the other day, there was a car accident.
No, that's how they demonize the police, is shelling them on evil, unconstitutional garbage, which then they carry out, destroying their own name.
Yeah, a small percentage of the bad apples are going to do this. And then it makes it look really bad. But then they say, oh, it's okay for your funding. It's okay. These people are probably drug dealers anyway. Just take their money. It goes to help the kids.
You talk about discrimination. Let's face it. They're going to target illegal aliens and black people and folks because somehow, this is the only racism I see left in the country, is with poor whites, blacks, or Hispanics. It's just kind of seen like as an asset forfeiture. That's who they do it to. Now, when it's an old lady, an old Hispanic lady or an old white lady or whatever, then, oh, there'll be a big investigation because, Martha Johnson, hypothetical name, Jane Doe, was an 82-year-old Baptist preacher's wife when they took her $2,000. I mean, they're dumb
enough.
You're
totally right.
These corrupt cops even dumb enough to rob old women. So let's face it. They pull somebody over that's got 5 narcotics convictions. In their view, they're sick of the justice system being corrupt. They're going to go ahead and just suck the money out. But then that leads to really bad stuff.
Then you can justify anything.
You target innocent people.
You can justify anything. You're totally right. Guess what? There is real racism, and we're against it. We're against it. But there is real racism, and that's a justification route, though. Because, yeah, you can take the guy with the priors and take his cash, but what are you going to do?
I'll tell you what's racism. I was at Big Bend and watched Hispanic officers who were not like, you know, the normal tough cop officers that you see, whether they be white, Hispanic, whatever. They were like little communist guys, and the things they were saying were right out of university, and they were just arresting white people and leaving the Hispanics alone for drinking. And I guess in their mind, oh, we're gonna do it back to you now. No, how about we just don't act like this? You know, I've had Mexican police shake me down for money because I'm a gringo. But you know what? They do it to Mexicans, too. It's wrong no matter who you do it to.
We all need to go back to kindergarten.
I mean, I'm the type of guy, if I was ordered as a cop to arrest people drinking beer, I would absolutely arrest one white guy and one Hispanic guy. You know, I wouldn't just sit there and, like, only take the white people to jail or give them tickets. It's sickening, man. It's sickening. I mean, I would be sick if I was a white police officer and pulled over a black family and then sucked the money out of their credit card. What the hell is this?
Think about that. You really think about what they do, too. It's like something, the numbers here, it's like $47 million or something.
And this just started a year ago.
Yeah. This is, and it's not just Oklahoma. Imagine a poor family that's in the car with kids screaming, crying, and you're like, I'm going to have to take that
credit card. Well, what they say is, well, where'd you get this $1,000? Or what you're doing with this? I'm going to go ahead and just, or, you know. Usually they find a bunch of cash and they say, we think it's drug related.
Yep.
I'm going to skip this break. I just have to do it right now. Anthony, do you want to just go ahead and play the insane piece now?
Yeah, let's play the insane piece. I like it. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is real. This is the real deal. This was captured footage from yesterday. I heard the screams from over on the other side of the building. This is what Alex actually was found to do. I was scared.
Buckley described it as the mad scientist who's gone to the fifth dimension from Buckaroo Banzai when he kind of runs away screaming crazy. And I said, Buckley, you're so smart. In fact, we should come back from the next segment with the Buckaroo Banzai intro. We have that in there because I was trying to actually imitate. What's that guy's name that's the bad guy in Buckaroo Banzai? Because that's exactly who I was trying to act like when I did it. And so, of course, when I ran with my legs far apart like a goblin, I looked like a goblin.
You were channeling the villain from Buckaroo Banzai.
I was trying to look like a goblin. That's why I did. I was trying to look like a Hillary supporter. But, yes, this is Alex Jones under the spell of Hillary the goddess. Here it is.
Now, this is take one of the Second Amendment piece. Going to do a dry run here so everybody's good with the audio. Okay, let's start. Okay. Hillary Clinton is going to be your Democratic nominee. Now, Mrs. Clinton is a very conservative person.
Joe, Travis, you guys, you got to come help me, man. Alex is freaking out.
I don't know what he's doing.
He lost his mind or something.
I mean,
I've never seen him do this before. It's totally out of character. Help, guys, come.
Lose their minds. He's been infected by Hillary Rodham Clinton. Don't let this happen to you. Get your Hillary for Prison t-shirt today.
Get your blasphemous Hillary for Prison t-shirt before Hillary outlaws them or Alex has them all destroyed. Go to store.infowars.com today and buy your Hillary for Prison t-shirt.
Or InfoWars. Or InfoWarsStore.com. By the way, can you back it up to about 10 seconds for the end? I love how Jakari's in there. We're in this main studio. Right next door is David Knight, who we didn't tell we were going to do this. Like, right through the wall, doing the show while we run around the fourth hour screaming and acting like morons. You know, at like 2:55 when we shot it. And then later he's like, what's screaming? What's going on? Comes walking out. The real sitcom, the real reality show would be Mount Cameras in here for the craziness that goes on, Anthony.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And I like how the end is. Buy them before they sell out or before Alex destroys them all. It's the real threat.
Yeah, so there's Jakari, like, you know, talking about Alex has been taken over by Hillary. In the background is David Knight trying to finish the show. You can see him, like putting his finger to there. He was asking him, like, oh, what's going on? Because we're like, we should have told him. I'm like screaming at the top of my lungs, and like right through that back wall is David Knight. Other people are like, what is going on? I'm actually crying. It's so funny. Let's get serious. It's how we fund the operation. That is another limited edition shirt. It says, till the end of time. That version's about to go. We're going to have a new one that doesn't say that. It says, Hillary for President 2016, the exact same design, except red on the shoulder, Infowars.com, to spread the word better. It'll keep it on the back as well, Infowars.com, legalize freedom. And that helps fund this operation. I'm constantly, you know, plugging every hour. Most talk shows plug 4 or 5 times an hour during the show, and that's what you got to do. Talk radio is going bankrupt. The whole country's in crisis. But we just do it once or twice an hour. By the way, I didn't mean to do this, but Anthony, tell folks about Living Defense. This sold out, in 2 days when it came in last year. I had no idea that the nutraceutical folks, the nutraceutical buffs, the nutraceutical vitamin mineral Nazis, and I mean that in a Seinfeld way, like, you know, the guy with the really good soups, a soup Nazi, but has weird rules. They really like it because they love Dr. Grip and what he does. But this thing's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Okay, 24 ingredients. I was saying close to 30. I was going off memory. And you take 1 to 3 capsules a day, do a 6-week cleanse on this because parasites get killed pretty quick, but then they have eggs and stuff and cyst. But most parasites are gone within 6 weeks, have completed their life cycle several times. And boy, folks take this. The reviews are unbelievable. But I had no idea this would become, like, out of the gates, one of the number one detox anti-parasite harmful organism cleanses out there. We finally got more of it in because there's so many ingredients to get them all organic, all tested, all California standard is really hard.
Yeah.
I mean, they set the bar, you know, where the air is dirtier than, you know, what they allow.
Or an
where
apple.
An apple is toxic. And so now it's here, and you folks, everybody should do this cleanse. Now, this is all seen as safe, you know, grass by the FDA, but still, that's a law, so it's called GRASS, meaning it's seen as in the safe vitamin and mineral and supplement herb body. We don't sell stuff that isn't in that group. But you should still talk to your physician because, hey, you may need a physician's note to breathe oxygen. The UN says, you know, the carbon dioxide's evil too. But get your Living Defense today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139 because, and this is the big enchilada, look at what we're doing at Bilderberg. Look at what we're doing covering the riots and the anti-Trump stuff. It's InfoWars so many times is a game changer because of the amplifier a lot of times, Drudge Report. I'm proud of the fact sometimes we're able to change course of things without Drudge linking, but Drudge, you know, is on the same team of Liberty, so it's a great dynamic duo, drudgereport.com. But, I mean, talk about Living Defense and just about what's happening in the media, Anthony, and then I'm going to throw the baton to you.
Absolutely. Well, Living Defense is, for me, it's a bestseller because you don't actually... And I hate to say this, but you don't have to do anything. So you just take it in the morning. You take it in the morning, you take it at night. It's not like you have to go through a cleanse protocol. You take
it. A lot of stuff's rough, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So some of it, I mean, hey, I love the Liver Shield. I love the liver cleanse, the advanced liver cleanse. It works, the real deal. It has tons of 5-star reviews. It's good.
But you're starring in the movie Alien.
But you have to do some stuff. Or you can take Liver Shield, just put it in your protein shake. But with Living Defense, again, I hate to say it, you literally don't have to do anything. You just take the capsules. That's it. Your cleanse is done. You
put but a lot the capsules of folks do report mouth, within a swallow. Week, though, it does cause a flush.
Well, you know, it depends on what you got in your body. Plus, it has the enzymes in there, which can break down the shield, so-called, of these harmful organisms in your body. And I don't know about you,
why are you being racist against tapeworms and
I'm being racist against tapeworms, and I like sushi a lot. I really, really like sushi. And you know how many harmful organisms are in a piece of sushi?
Oh, my gosh. I used to see these videos where they pour Coke on, like, pork and worms come out. I didn't believe it.
Yeah.
A few months ago, I don't eat a lot of pork just because it's for me. The point is, because I always just hear stuff about it. I like bacon, though. And I was sitting there, and there was frickin' worms in it. And I meant to videotape it, but it was so gross, I didn't do it. It's going to be a viral video.
You know what's sad, though? The worms that you don't see are still on there.
Yeah, the edge.
Especially when you go to a sushi place, and let's say it's not the best sushi place, they get the filler fish. And they let it sit there and they just put it and wrap it in the rice. You realize that's raw fish. Nothing has been done to it. Nothing has been done to even sear it and kill anything in there. There's a lot
of... That's why they say a lot of models don't just eat sushi to lose weight because it's low calorie. They want to get the worms.
Some people want the tapeworms so that it sucks the nutrients, which is the silliest, most insane thing ever. It was popular in Japan for a while.
I think Hillary Clinton is a giant tapeworm.
I think she's stealing our nutrients and we need to Living Defense her out of the country.
I'm going to say this. Not only do I think Michelle Obama is a tranny, I believe I believe Hillary Clinton is a giant intergalactic tapeworm that traveled here via the ninth dimension and is actually wearing a rubber mask. In fact, let's play the video for TV viewers just of her up there on stage when she puts the rubber mask on and turns into the Joker. Why do you think the giant worm chose the Joker mask?
Well, you know, it's a certain look, right? I think as a giant intergalactic multidimensional ethereal tapeworm, she's going to want to look a certain way, you know? And if that is the case, which I'm sure it is, I'm sure there's researchers have concluded that she is, in fact, a tapeworm.
Well, I heard she also carries all those cat worms that are in the brain, and she just vomits them into the school lunch program food.
Yeah, what? The cat worms. You know, nobody believes the cat worms. Nobody believes a lot of the stuff. Scientists are growing organs of pigs.
Being serious. No one believes that there's that worm that gets in the snail that makes it go to the top of the tree to be eaten by birds to then put its spores back out for more snails, and it actually gets into the brain and remote controls the snail.
And on a serious note too, no, that is real, obviously. There is a lot of theories that the parasites that we're eating every single day that we can't do anything about that are just going in us, a lot of those parasites could be behind disease in a number of, like, it could be
sure. And folks, I'm being sarcastic about her being a tapeworm. Now Michelle Obama does have a tapeworm in her pants, but I'm being serious about the worms that go in and take over the brain of the snail, and that cats carry a worm that gets into your brain and makes you enjoy the smell of cat pee so you have more of the cats around. That is actually real. In fact, Anthony, pull those up during the break. People think I'm making this up. I shouldn't make satire and mix in with real stuff, but I'm going to say it. She's not a tapeworm. She's actually a brain worm from a cat. Anthony Gucciardi is hosting the fourth hour with yours truly. He wants to get to this big Drudge piece. I know we're running out of time here. Maybe we should air it in the fourth hour tomorrow, but I'll let Anthony take over. But I briefly wanted to mention something because I heard David Knight talking about it, and I meant to cover it the last few days. You have the precariat, and that's a merger of precarious with the proletariat, meaning the general slave population. In sociology and economics, the precariat is a social class. Well, they have this political scientist who's written a book about it, and it's one of the 10 topics they admit they're covering in their press release of the group that didn't exist until a few years ago because we were crazy. The world's most elite conference this year will discuss something called the precariat. And they go on to say, yeah, we've gotten rid of the middle class, and so there's these giant masses of young people with no future. We need to all give them money, just random money, but have state controls over them to control them. But I've always told you the plan is to make you dependent. The Bilderberg Group is openly admitting and mainlining, and you see European countries calling for this check you get. You got to take vaccines, got to do what they say about how many kids you can have. We're always told there's too many people on welfare having 10 kids. Yeah, they set it up like that to then have the cultural backlash, have a big, giant, uneducated mass of people of all races, colors, and creeds rioting if their EBT card doesn't work in a few days. Already happening. You show the poor woman, you know, stomping around the grocery store after her EBT card doesn't work. EBT cards are now failing. It's a time bomb to then control the producers. And then there'll just be a move towards phasing out the lower class, and then it'll be phase everybody out as they get the robots in place where they'll produce everything for us, but then we'll have to socially go along with whatever the controllers tell us we must do. And David Knight did a great job breaking that down in a 60-second piece that aired, because we've gotten rid of a lot of the commercials here. Commercials have been obsolete on radio and TV to a certain extent for about 10 years. If we don't produce just incredibly amazing commercials, they don't give you an effect. If you've got all great commercials on radio or TV, yes, and make a, you know, turn them into a big deal like the Super Bowl, then they're successful. That's why you see radio and TV and everywhere. It's product placement within the show. Most of it's hidden. We plug a few times an hour max, and it's all out in the open. Hey, we're selling you something we believe in, we use. I'm just digressing that we bring vignettes to the radio feeds and the video feeds. A lot of our stuff isn't even commercials. It's just promoting freedom, because the currency we're looking for is human survival. And not deciding it's the end of humanity, not deciding we don't matter, not deciding we're going to be phased out, and then I supposedly join the elite and go along with this and lose my soul. You build a system of dehumanization, it will suck everyone in. No one will escape. Turn back now, warned the sentry at the four-way stop. This way lies hell. This way lies honor and the Dark Tower. Roland. Child Roland, the Dark Tower came. Read that poem and know it. Or be the dead, rotting horse in the moat. All right, let's just go back to Anthony Gucciardi. Anthony, I'm going to turn this over to you and let you honcho and run the rest of the transmission. Appreciate you coming in to host the fourth hour. I have to twist Anthony's arm to do this, and then I take over anyways. But Just great job, my friend. Please continue.
Hey, thank you. And by the way, the name of the cat parasite, I couldn't remember it. It's toxoplasmosis. And what happens is basically your cats go outside and they get infected by this parasite. They bring it in. It goes into your brain. It's been linked to schizophrenia. That's why they may have called it the crazy cat woman back in the day, because the woman with the 20 cats or whatever, they would have a massive amount of toxoplasmosis. And The Atlantic says how your cat is making you crazy. Scientific American says,
massive suicide increases.
Yep, toxoplasmosis. None of it exists.
And we talk to women we know who have cats, and they literally laugh at us and will not listen.
They say we're insane. And I've said it time and time again. For those
you hear the thing, crazy cat lady, where they love the cats everywhere and the pee everywhere. It programs you to love the smell of the pee with the toxins in it of the brainworm. It's literally science fiction.
Yes, it sounds
pull
crazy.
Up the snail that's mind controlled by a worm too. That's on Discovery Channel.
It all sounds crazy. And guess what? It is crazy. Well, the life is crazy. The world's insane. A meteor could hit us right now. We could die. We could be in a car accident. Something could blow up. A nuclear explosion could happen. The world's insane.
Point is, we're not in Kansas anymore.
Yeah,
and there's other interdimensional succubus parasites, the Bible and every culture say, that are feeding on us as well.
Who knows? All
and
I
Hillary
know,
Clinton is completely run by it.
There you go. Well, she is one. Big worm. But
no, I mean, she's run by a seventh dimensional buck-toothed goblin named Pink Belly.
The evidence is clear. The
Media Matters of America.
Yes.
That's my God, you've right got there. A shot of Hillary Clinton with her makeup off. Here, let's show folks this. World's deadliest zombie snail. See? That's a National Geographic.
Zombie snails.
That's the general public are like zombie snails.
What's they're the deadliest.
Isn't it credible, though? As you said, incredible. That we're like making up words here and engaging in bonics, Anthony. You go ahead and take over.
I'll tell you what. I don't like to hate on the general public. I think we've turned into a headline society. I think they've been conditioned. We've all been conditioned. I've been conditioned. I'm not above anything to look at headlines and to not realize the details. And that's why we are going to be destroyed if we don't listen.
All right, I'm
going to
leave, but they found it. It's Dr. Emilio Lizardo from the movie Buckaroo Banzai. So can we play the theme of Buckaroo Banzai one more time as they cue this up? John Harmon, can you find that again? Just let me know when you have it. This is why I quit doing the fourth hour.
Crashing through the lies and disinformation.
Because when I've been on air 3 hours, after that I begin to
Jones on the GCN
turn into my
Radio
real self.
Network.
This is a big goofball.
Yeah.
Who?
I like it.
Who would be crazy enough to actually take on the New World Order and win? Now, as this is rolling together, mix the two, let's show people a clip of Emilio Lizardo. There you go. Turn up the audio on that, please. Can you guys pull up Emilio Lizardo, Buckaroo Banzai? I know that clip will be one of the first ones on YouTube, and then show that with his hair all sticking out. He's like, the overthruster. I mean, that's what these Democrat supporters are like. It's like they've been possessed. Did you see all the interviews Leanne did? She couldn't find any Democrat supporters that weren't deranged loons.
I think we should show the snails, too.
Did we find it? Here, can we please find Emilio Lizardo? Or Buckaroo
Banzai? This is key stuff. Actually, it's good because, you know, you talk about serious stuff all day. This is, it's fun to do this every now.
A curse of you, a Buckaroo Banzai. All right, it's yours. I'm leaving, Anthony. I have a lot of work to do.
Hey, we always come here and have fun and talk about this stuff. And then you say, all right, I'm leaving. Now you get serious. Now you talk about.
Oh, there's Lizardo right there. Back it up. Let's see him. I did that just from memory, and it was funny Buckley picked up on it. Here we go. Here, let's turn up the audio on this. Oh, there's no audio? Okay. All right, that's it. Lizardo's left the building, and so have I. Anthony, go ahead.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Got news here I want to cover, including this craziness. Scientists growing human organs inside pigs to create chimeras. But guess what? They've been making chimeras for a long, long time. Got stories about that. And back in the day when we used to talk about it, I would talk about it. I heard Alex talking about it a long, long time ago. Oh, that's craziness. You're crazy. Chinese cows making human breast milk from 6-7 years ago. Human animal chimeras were already unlocked and discovered in the UK. It's all craziness. But guess what? Like I said, like we were talking about earlier, the world is crazy. We've got more about Oklahoma police seizing your bank account and how they can do that. Towns banning front yard gardens. Venezuelan middle class dumpster diving for food. We're going to talk about a lot of that. But first, what I wanted to do, and it's pressing. We're going to have to cut off the end of it, and you can see the rest on the Alex Jones YouTube channel. Is I wanted to play this full Drudge video because we played the 2-minute version of the Drudge warning before. Yesterday, we played it a little bit today and yesterday. But this video really summarizes all of it. When Matt Drudge came and came on Alex's show, he really hit a lot of key points. So if we have that ready, I know it's a lot of craziness going on back there in the production area. I would like to play Matt Drudge's warning to America.
It's been more than 16 years since Matt Drudge gave his historic speech at the National Press Club on June 2nd, 1998. At that time, he said that the mainstream media would go bankrupt, that individual bloggers and researchers on the internet were just as important as the New York Times. The controlled state-run media had a field day making fun of Matt Drudge. But today, their hubris has drained away, and they're no longer as arrogant as they once were. Now we see calls for the FCC to regulate print news and online news, and we see establishment publications like Time Magazine, Newsweek, and the New York Times battling to keep from going completely bankrupt and imploding. It turns out pretty much everything that Matt Drudge said in that 40-minute speech has now come true. Well, Matt Drudge is saying a lot of things today that the mainstream media is still laughing at. Why do they laugh at people that have been proven right over and over again? Here are some of the most important moments, in my view, from Drudge's speech. And we're also adding headlines from over the years to show just how much of what he had to say came true.
This is something new. This marks the first time that an individual has access to the news wires outside of a newsroom. You get to read all the news from the Associated Press, UPI, Reuters, to the more okay agency French press and the Xinhua. I'm a personal fan of the Xinhua press. And time was, only newsrooms had access to the full pictures of the day's events. But now any citizen does. We get to see the kinds of cuts that are made for all kinds of reasons. Endless layers of editors with endless agendas changing bits and pieces, so by the time the newspaper hits your welcome mat, it had no meaning. Now with a modem, anyone can follow the world and report on the world. No middleman, no big brother. And I guess this changes everything.
More than 10 years after breaking the Clinton-Lewinsky story, Matt Drudge remains more powerful than ever with his website, thedrudgereport.com.
Matt Drudge is a legend on the internet. Every journalist and politician in America reads his website on a daily basis.
When radio lost out to television, there was anxiety. The people in the radio business were absolutely anxious and demanded government stop the upcoming television wave. Television was very nervous about other mediums coming forward, cable. The movies didn't want sitcoms to be taped at movie studios for fear it would take away from the movies. No, television saved the movies. The internet is going to save the news business. I envision a future where there'll be 300 million reporters, where anyone from anywhere can report for any reason. It's freedom of participation absolutely realized. The First Lady of the United States recently addressed concerns about internet during a cyberspatial Millennium Project press conference just weeks after Lewinsky broke. She said, we're all going to have to rethink how we deal with the internet. As exciting as these new developments are, there are a number of serious issues without any kind of editing function or gatekeeping function. I wonder who she was referring to. Mrs. Clinton continued, any time an individual leaps so far ahead of that balance and throws a system whatever it might be, political, economic, technological, out of balance, you got a problem. It can lead to all kinds of bad outcomes, which we have seen historically.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
Would she have said the same thing about Ben Franklin, or Thomas Edison, or Henry Ford, or Einstein? They all leapt so far ahead out that they shook the balance. No, I say to these people, faster, not slower. Create. Let your mind flow. Let the imagination take over. And if technology has finally caught up with individual liberty, why would anyone who loves freedom want to rethink that?
If you're an undersecretary at the Energy Department and you're doing an interview and you say one thing, you know, during, you could end up being on the front page of Drudge. Anyone saying anything can get caught up in the spin cycle in a way that is very damaging. You know, it hurts what we're trying to do on a daily basis, but also is very damaging to that individual person.
And we cannot hide our bad news stories. Bad news gets out one way or the other, and we must come to terms with telling the bad stories as well as the good. When bad things happen, the American people should hear it from us, not as a scoop on the Drudge Report.
The editor of Civilization magazine, Adam Goodhart, wrote a great op-ed in the New York Times talking about, is this really something new, this type of fast reporting, this competitive, very competitive, I'm part of the headline generation. He maintains it was a going back to our foundations when the press was found in quite a different atmosphere, when the press would report that the president's mother was a common prostitute brought over by the British Army. Imagine if someone did that now. We have a great tradition of freedom of the press in this country, unpopular press. If the First Lady is concerned about this internet cycle, what would she have done during the heyday when there was 12, 13 editions of a paper in one day? What would she have done with that news cycle? That's the foundation. That's what makes this club great, is the tradition. And I think we have a tradition of provocative press. And that I maintain that I'm the new face on that. I'll take that for a season. But a lot of the stuff I do is serious stuff. I was first to report that the encryption was missing from a Loral satellite, for example, a couple weeks ago. I didn't see the main press reporting that one. So not everything I do is gossip or bedroom. To the contrary, I think that's just an easy label to dismiss me and to dismiss the new medium. But I'm excited about the launch of this internet medium, and I freedom of the press belongs to anyone who owns one.
Tonight, the Drudge Report and InfoWars are once again in the crosshairs as the U.S. government seeks to regulate conservative media via election laws.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist whose stories often make their way from his website, InfoWars, where on any day you can find headlines about vaccines, mass fluoridation, and the 9/11 cover-up, into the so-called mainstream GOP establishment. Alex Jones was a champion of Clive and Bundy from the very beginning.
Because he's saying he'll do whatever he has to not be, have his grazing rights stolen by these pirates.
Drudge elevated the story, and it made its way onto Fox News' airwaves. Next thing you know, so-called mainstream Republicans are calling people like this patriots.
The conservative website that's called The Drudge Report pulled out all the stops today to promote a big, new bombshell video.
Today, the leading conservative website's headline was this: Civil War Senate to go for handguns.
I'm an addict. I'm a Drudge addict. Actually, my homepage is actually something else, National Review, but I find myself going to Drudge all the time because as a communications professional, you can tell what's going to come down the pike. If there's a siren on Drudge Report, you're like, oh boy, better go knock on the Oval Office door and let them know what's going to happen.
Walkergate. Yes, we're calling it that. It's the latest Hillary conspiracy theory that set the internet ablaze after the Drudge Report questioned whether Clinton was using a walker in this People magazine cover photo.
Well, internet pioneer Matt Drudge created a firestorm over the weekend, tweeting, "Just paid the Obamacare penalty for not getting covered. I'm calling it a liberty tax."
But a White House representative firing back, tweeting, "Flat lie, no fee for previous years." Scary how much influence he once had.
And then the White House shot back and said, you know, made some cheap shot about, oh, he used to be relevant. Are you kidding me? Matt Drudge used to be relevant? Let me give you the numbers. In 1 month, go on the website, 800, almost 810 million unique views on the Drudge Report.
I guess that's a nice Twitter fight between the White House and Matt Drudge.
People had suggested I start a mailing list. So I collected the emails and set up a list called the Drudge Report. One reader turned into five, then turned into 100. And faster than you could say, I never had sex with that woman, it was 1,000, 5,000, 100,000 people. The ensuing website practically launched itself.
That is the video about what Matt Drudge said ultimately all coming true. And it's the most amazing thing when he was talking about, I foresee an age in which the internet will allow there to be 300 million reporters. 300 million reporters. And it ties in to this idea I wanted to talk about today. And of course, there's so much news that we didn't get to cover. I'm going to try and cover some of it. But the idea that we live in what I call a standardized test society. Because you see, you're only given options. Or you could also call it A, B, C, or D society. What I mean by that is from childhood, we're put into the school system where we're given tests. And these tests are standardized. They grade us and our value and our worth and our intelligence based on A, B, C, or D. Sometimes you might be able to write in your own answer, right? But the big ones, the SATs, all these big grand tests, the standardized tests from the states, from the system, right? It's all A, B, C, or D. And we've been accustomed to this idea that we can either choose A, B, C, or D. We have to watch either Fox News, MSNBC, whatever you want to watch, as long as it's mainstream media. Right? A, B, C, or D. Sometimes there's not even a C or D. Sometimes it's A or B. You've been told your entire lives you have to subscribe to this system, the standardized test society, where you have no individual choice, where you can't do your own thing, right? Even when you graduate high school, they give you a test to determine your career based on this test. And there's a list of careers that you're going to be. It's very 1984-esque. And they say, well, you would be best as a plumber. You wrote these multiple choice questions because we don't have the capacity to see people individually. You wrote these multiple choice questions and we determined that you would most likely be best as a plumber. Well, you know, Matt Drudge didn't see just A, B, C, or D. He saw the internet, which a lot of the mainstream media type people hated because it was access points for us, the individuals, to do our thing, just like how I'm speaking to you right now is through the internet or through radio, which was enabled by Alex's presence on the internet. And what happens is you start to lose control. The system starts to lose control. And Drudge saw that. No matter even what you think about him or the Drudge Report, maybe you even hate the politics of it. But guess what? He was a trailblazer and he was a mega genius. And he is still a mega genius in the sense that he saw all of this coming. He saw all of this happening and he saw it for what it was, an opportunity of expansion into the idea bank of the world. And instead of being someone that was sitting there saying the internet is bad and scary and evil and it is a terrible thing and we need to restrict control and the government needs to regulate it, he said this is a bounty of opportunity. And he said there will be attacks on the freedom of the internet. And he came on to Alex's show. Alex's program has said such powerful things. I mean, really, really powerful. And speaking to the guy, he's a really amazing human being. But the very concept, we now have these tools, these opportunities at our disposal. Just this cell phone right here, this phone I'm holding in my hand is opportunity. It is the ability to do anything. It is the ability to reach people through any venue online that you could have never dreamed of. It's more powerful than a supercomputer in the 1950s that cost $50 million. You would just have it in your hand all day sitting there. You have the opportunity to actually do something with it that could change the world. You could actually take a video on your phone and change the planet. That is powerful stuff. And the people that saw that from the beginning were people like Matt Drudge. And, you know, Alex saw it too. He was the first to start streaming his program live on the internet, like you are now probably watching it at Infowars.com/show. So this is what it comes down to. These are the things that change the world. These are the things and the opportunities that we need to grasp and take a hold of. Now, quickly, before the program's over, and Alex comes back tomorrow from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central, I just wanted to hit on just a few things here that are happening. So we talk about the details. We talk about toxoplasmosis, the cat parasite. Well, now scientists are growing organs inside pigs to create chimeras. This is from The Independent. U.S. researchers have injected human stem cells into pig embryos to produce human pig embryos known as chimeras. Now, this isn't new. Only got a minute here, but this isn't new news. In 2011, Sky News reported Chinese GM cows are already making human breast milk. And we've known for a long time that human animal chimeras are being made. They face new ethical scrutiny. This was from Stat News in 2015. And this piece from 2012 on 10 ways science is using human-animal hybrids. There's tons of different so-called chimeras already in existence. It's already being done. And here's the thing about this. We need to get involved in things that are actually detailed like this as a society instead of being a headline society. You heard about the drive-by society? How about a headline society? We just read headlines on the media, make assumptions, don't read past the first paragraph, and leave. We're tired, we're exhausted, we've been worked to the bone, we've been attacked, right? We don't have time, but guess what? We got to get engaged, because as they start churning out human chimeras without the public even realizing it, we're not even involved. We're too busy. As they pull over people on the side of the road in Oklahoma and take all their cash, we're not even involved because we're too busy caught up in the minutia junk, the distraction. We have to get aligned and get on par. Anyway, I'm Anthony Gucciardi, and this has been the fourth hour of the Alex Jones Show. Alex, thank you for inviting me on. A lot of fun this hour. And stay tuned tomorrow. Alex will be back 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central.